following is a special presentation of Raycom Sports, home to regional college football and basketball.
Hey, y'all, this is Bridget Tatum, and you're watching ACC football on Raycom Sports.
Chapel Hill for the 100th meeting between the Wolfpack of NC State and the Tar Heels of North Carolina. The Wolfpack is still very much in the hunt for the Atlantic Division title. With their eyes on the prize, NC State will try to make it four in a row over Carolina. But the Tar Heels are honoring 17 seniors in their farewell game here at Chapel Hill. NC State is 7-3. North Carolina is 6-4. More than 60,000 fans have gathered here to watch this good old-fashioned backyard brawl. Hi, everybody. I'm Tim Brand, along with Dave Archer. Glad to have you along. NC State rides in here with a red-hot quarterback in Russell Wilson.
Russell Wilson leads the ACC in passing yards, total yards, and touchdown passes. 7 300-yard games for the junior signal caller. But his ability to adjust to defense, what he sees each and every Saturday, and it's been a myriad of things. Man coverage, zone coverage, and he added an extra element. That's run the football. He's rushed for 6 touchdowns in the last 4 games. Simple thing about Russell Wilson, he's going to find a way to beat you.
This is the last game for T.J. Yates in Carolina. Fifth-year senior, he's got to control his emotions today.
He really does. John Shoup, offensive coordinator, describes T.J. Yates as tough and gritty, and that's exactly what he is. He's done an outstanding job through his career. He's had a solid career the first 3 years, but his senior year, he has stepped it up. 65% completion percentage, 2-1 in the touchdown-to-interception ratio. He has been the biggest when the Tar Heels have needed him the most. A solid signal caller in his final game.
Carolina Ford keys to the game. Take a look at these.
For the Wolfpack, they've got to come and attack on both sides of the football. That's what they've been all year long. Don't change now. ACC title in the distance. And for North Carolina, they've got to be who they are. It's not about North Carolina State. They looked inside themselves. They've lost 3 straight in this series. Find a way to concentrate on what you do and go do it the best you can.
So for the 100th time, it's State and Carolina, two schools steeped in tradition, separated by only 20 miles. It's senior day for the Tar Heels. It's a title run for the Wolfpack. And it's coming up next from Chapel Hill, North Carolina.
ACC football is being brought to you by AT&T, by Havilland, by CPI Security Systems, by GEICO, and by BB&T.
NC State comes out into Kenan Stadium with a record of 7-3. 4-2 in the conference. The Wolfpack can win the division title with a win today and a win next week at Maryland. Nestled in the pines with the well, the bell, and the stone walls, we are in Kenan Stadium. And here come the Tar Heels.
a record of 6-4. They lost to Virginia Tech last week 26-10. They've had adversity, but this is a rival game, and they don't forget. The third member of our broadcast team is Mike Hogwood, roaming the sidelines, giving us perspective from the field. Michael, what do you have?
All right, Tim. Well, as you well know, when you have a rival game, it often comes down to somebody making a play, somebody making a big play, and there are a couple of big play linebackers on either side today. First for NC State, there's Nate Irving. He's gotten better every game after recovering from that car crash. He had 8 tackles for loss against Wake Forest. That's absolutely incredible. He's playing the best football of his career right now. And then on the other side, there's Bruce Carter. He is a tremendous athlete. Not only does he make plays at linebacker, but how about special teams? In his career, he has 7 block punts. Expect a big play from Bruce Carter here today. They're ready to go for the 100th time. NC State and North Carolina kickoff on the way from Chapel Hill in a moment.
ACC football is brought to you in high definition by H.H. Gregg. You'll find the biggest selection at the lowest prices. H.H. Gregg, price and advice guaranteed. NC State won the toss and elected to defer. So NC State will kick off, and Carolina will have it first. Chris Hawthorne is to kick off, and he'll be kicking to these men, number 21, Denoris Searcy, and number 25, Matt Merletti. There's DeCircy, and he is dangerous. We are told that we still will see Josh Chikowski today as a kicker. He was said to be out for the season with a pulled hamstring. But it is Hawthorne to kick off for the Wolfpack. This is a low knuckleball taken by the up man at the 20. That's Wilson, and Wilson is across the 30, and that's where Carolina will have it first.
Tim, we get a chance to see a great senior quarterback now, T.J. Yates, and he lost his top-flight receiver, Zach Pianalto, and he's decided to throw it to Dwight Jones, outstanding deep receiver. Dwight Jones has stepped up big time, averaging 17.6 yards a catch, a dangerous combination, Yates to Jones.
T.J. Yates is a time-tested veteran, making his 42nd start today. He's 6'4", 220 pounds from Marietta, Georgia. First down, Tar Heels. The give to the outside, Elsey. Good, solid game. Knocked out of bounds by Earl Wolf. CPI starting lineup. North Carolina's backs and receivers have decimated by sanctions and injuries. Carolina's top 4 backs are gone. Senior Anthony Elsey, who just carried it, gets the start. Dwight Jones, the leading receiver. The offensive line, 2 seniors, a junior, a sophomore, and James Hurst, the true freshman. All are over 300 pounds. A pickup of 5. It'll be second down. Yates, first pass. Complete. First down, Tar Heels. Finds his big tight end, Ed Barham, who's 6'3", 270. The Wolfpack defense isn't that complicated, but the players swarm to the football. Front 4, somewhat undersized, very, very quick. Rieskamp, Muggio, Sweezy, and Akini. The Wolfpack linebackers are the heart and soul of this defense. Cole and Manning are really good. Nate Irvin is better than that. Wilson and Amerson are the cover corners. Bishop and Wolf the safeties. NC State's defense has allowed a total 17 points the last 2 games. First down, Tar Heels. 2 plays, 10 yards, move the chains. It's a rival game. Elsey again, not much there this time. A pickup of maybe 1. J.R. Sweezy made the tackle.
Well, Tim, we already see the patience of T.J. Yates and what he's going to have to do at the line of scrimmage against this Wolfpack defense. Find a way to get them in the best play possible. Saw in that second throw, he did a great job of getting the ball to his tight end after his first receiver was taken away. On the last play, he changed the strength of the play from one side of the formation to the other. T.J. Yates, make no mistake, is in complete command.
The team that has held the rushing advantage has won this game 16 of the last 18 meetings. Yates to throw, complete, knocked loose, balls up for grabs. Carolina got it back. Barham made the catch, made a football move, and was hit by Cole, who knocked it loose.
Tim, you mentioned these linebackers, the heart and soul of this team, and I'm going to go one step further. This might be the best three linebackers in the country playing together. Excellent job of getting back to the football. Joshua Adams got back on the ball for North Carolina, but this set of linebackers, great speed, great size, and they will flat get after you. And they're led by Nate Irving. You heard Hogwood talk about, Mike Hogwood talk about 8.5 tackles for loss, an FBS record.
First third down and 8 we have of this ball game. Here comes the pressure. Yates rolling. Throws underneath to Elsie. He's got some space. And down to the 45-yard line, but it'll be short of the first down, a pickup of 6 yards. Dante Johnson made the stop.
Well, for North Carolina State, it's going to be about pressuring the senior quarterback and limiting his chances and looks. You see Nate Irving giving chase, number 56, closes so quickly. But the veteran quarterback finds his check down. Elsie, running back, had over 100 yards receiving last week against Virginia Tech, but he could not get enough for the first down.
C.J. Fiegels is punting it, and Graham will look at this short kick and tell everybody to get out of the way, and it goes out of bounds at the 16-yard line. So a 29-yard punt.
Tim, do we get to see Russell Wilson, tremendous athlete at quarterback, and it was the game against Florida State where he really stepped up big and started this trend of running the football against an adjustment defenses are making, dropping 8 into coverage. He led his team all the way back, a 2-point conversion, put his team ahead, and then a late defensive stop. Huge win for NC State on a Thursday night against the Florida State Seminoles.
Look at his numbers against Carolina. Spectacular, especially the right side. 6 touchdowns, no interceptions. Throws on the first down to Washington, incomplete. James Washington gets the start at running back. Mustafa Green will get plenty of touches. Owen Spencer is the field stretcher. Jarvis Williams, a mismatch guy at 6'4". State's offensive line averages 308 pounds. Jake Vermiglio is a 4-year starter. The only senior on the line. Wallace, Wentz, Allen, Mattis, all solid. Russell Wilson, the trigger man. And at the top of the league in passing yardage. Extremely dangerous for cover guys because he can run as well as he can throw. Straight ahead goes Washington. A pickup of 6. Carolina's defense was one of the best in the nation when the season started, decimated by the NCAA investigation. Now Young across the front, no seniors in the lineup. Junior Quentin Copels has 7.5 sacks. Carolina's linebackers have been led by Zach Brown, but Carter, Reddick, and Sturdivant are all talented. Secondary, Deontay Williams, Kendrick Burney have come back and caused problems. Demure Searcy is the ball hawk. Carter gets his hand on it, and the Carolina captain makes a big play, and NC State will have to give it back.
Quick slant throw, looking to try to find his receiver to the inside, and Bruce Carter, outstanding senior linebacker, is going to elevate, watching Wilson's eyes, and bats the football away and generates a 3-and-out for the Tar Heel defense.
So Carolina should get great field position here. Searcy standing on the 33-yard line. Andy Loeffler, low snap, goes down and gets it. This is a low, spiraling kick taken by the up man and hit immediately. But it'll be good field position for Carolina, and there is a flag.
And this is a heck of a play by Kendrick Burney. The up man comes up and catches the short kick on a fair catch call and then was run into by an NC State cover man. But a good play by Burney to conserve the yardage.
Kick interference, number 47 of the kicking team. 15 yards from the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
Referee today is Brad Allen, and he's a good one. Tom O'Brien not happy with that. Tom O'Brien, the semifinalist for the inaugural Joe Paterno Coach of the Year Award, but still hearing it about 4th-and-1 at Clemson. I want you to remember that 15 minutes could save you 15% or more in car insurance. Call GEICO at 1-800-947-AUTO or visit geico.com. Look at John Shoup, offensive coordinator at North Carolina. That last punt by the Wolfpack was only 18 yards, so great starting field position in Wolfpack territory for T.J. Yates and the Tar Heels. Elsie, not much. In that first series, Yates set the All-time school record for attempts. Let's go downstairs to Mike.
Well, tailback has been a tough position for North Carolina this year. Johnny White was having a great year. He shattered his collarbone. Sean Drone has been injured much of the year. The job today is to Anthony Elzey, who's played fullback most of his career at North Carolina, getting a chance at tailback. Actually ran pretty well in the Tar Heels last game.
No question about that. Dinged up and beaten down. Second down and 10 at the 41 for Carolina. Yates looks over the defense, locates 56, throws the quick slant, has it to his tight end, and Barham rambles down, the ball's loose inside the 30. NC State says they've got it. No signal yet.
Boy, good job by getting the ball out. Looks like Nate
Wolfpack
Irving
comes out with it.
Looks like Nate Irving, the senior linebacker, is going to rake this out. Just an excellent job of Yates stuffing this into Barnum. And then Barnum trying to get a little extra yards. Watch 56. Rip it out of there. Nate Irving. Irving almost gets there before the ball gets there, but then he decides, hey, what else can I do? And this is what he does. He rips the ball out.
Brian Slay came up with it. And for Barnum, that's the second time he's lost the football. So Carolina squanders a great opportunity. They'll take another look at this. They're going to call timeout on the field. So they're going to review this. Brad Allen says timeout. Let's take another look.
Barham came in for Butch Davis. He had only caught 10 passes coming in. He's caught two today. Tim, you mentioned he laid both of them on the ground. Just 16 receptions coming in today in his career. So good job by Nate Irving to rip it out. I don't think there's any question that.
Well, they want to see if his knee was down before the ball came out.
I don't think there's any question the officials got this right.
So you know the catch was good. He took several steps. His right knee. Actually, that ball's out before anything hits.
Yeah, the officials were all over it. Did a great job of getting this one right the first time. And a good scramble by NC State getting to the football.
North Carolina turnovers have really been a problem in their four losses. Of course, last week they had the six turnovers, four interceptions, two fumbles. Butch Davis not happy about any of it. This has been some kind of season down here in Chapel Hill with the injuries and the investigation and the suspensions. Incredibly tough. But the coaching staff, I think, has done a marvelous job keeping these kids together and doing what they've done with the six wins and the four losses.
It's been incredible what the staff has been able to do. They had to adjust some assignments. Remember, John Blake was part of that whole scenario. He was fired. He was a defensive line coach here. They had to adjust some assignments. They've done an outstanding job having this team ready to play each and every week.
The ruling on the field stands. First down.
This game carrying a little extra weight because December 4th, the ACC Championship in Charlotte, North Carolina. And for that man right there, the road to Charlotte comes right smack through Chapel Hill.
Oh, what a great opportunity, though. We talked to Tom O'Brien on the phone, and he talked about how this is an opportunity to dream about. All we have to do is take care of our business, and they'll be standing in Charlotte at the end.
Spencer goes to the top of the screen. Davis to the bottom. Mustafa Green is your running back, and Wilson is going down. The sack by Bruce Carter. A loss of 8. And for Carter, he got in there in a hurry.
A little delayed blitz by Bruce Carter. He sees the back check up and block, so he shoots through the gap and puts Wilson on the ground. These two offensive lines have had a tough time protecting the quarterback all year long. In fact, North Carolina State and North Carolina come in as last, sharing the last position in protecting their quarterback on the year.
Carter is a Carolina captain, bench presses 440 pounds, has a 40-inch vertical leap, runs a sub-4.4. Wilson throws. This is Green. Green across the 25 and stopped by Carter. Mike Hogwood, what do you have?
Well, both of you guys probably remember your senior day. Some people react differently. Some guys are cool, some guys are really emotional. Bruce Carter, he was really emotional with his family before the game. And boy, has he come out ready to light it up here.
crowd on its feet. Third down and 12 for NC State. Wilson throws underneath. This is Gentry. Gentry's going to be close to the first down, but should be about a yard short. Zach Brown made the tackle.
Yeah, here he is right here, going to circle out of the backfield. Just a dump off here. And again, North Carolina playing a deep zone coverage. Let the ball be completed underneath and rally up to make the tackle. Now, I don't think they wanted it this close. And it's going to force a measurement, but they certainly wanted the ball thrown underneath. Gentry does a good job of getting north and south after he catches it. And now this is a close one.
While they measure, we'll keep you updated with the Geico scoreboard, top of the screen, updates on the scores, not only throughout the ACC, but throughout the entire country. This is closer than I thought. He got a good mark. First down, NC State.
I think North Carolina played that exactly the way they wanted to. They just didn't rally up quick enough. Gentry does a good job of having a sense of urgency when he caught it to get north and south on that third and 10 play to pick up a first down.
Tom O'Brien's teams play with discipline, traditionally one of the least penalized teams in the league. Dana Bible, outstanding offensive mind, healthy and fired up for this game.
Well, I got a chance to talk to him before the game, Tim. It's been a year ago today that he was diagnosed.
Mustafa Green, 1 yard, and that's it. Tydrick Powell will get credit for the tackle.
But I got a chance to talk to Dana before the game. Here he is, offensive coordinator. A year ago today, arrived right here at the UNC Medical Center with cancer. He's been 5 months cancer-free, and you could see it in his face, very emotional. He said he couldn't wait for the game to start so he could kind of concentrate on the game and not think back.
They need eight on second down, and Wilson throws this one up for grabs. I don't know how T.J. Graham got over there. He was in the center of the field when Wilson threw that and still almost made the completion.
Let's look outside and see what Bernie's sitting up tight. Now he's going to fall off. Good job of underneath coverage that time by Searcy.
Hit him in the helmet.
Yeah, banged out.
When Wilson threw that ball, Graham was on the hash marks.
Now, good pressure again by one of the linebackers. This time, Reddick, the middle linebacker, brought pressure. So a lot of linebacker stunts up front for North Carolina.
Third down and 8 for NC State. The quick out pattern. Going to be short of the first. Darrell Davis tried to break loose. A gain of 6.
Tim, all three linebackers come again. Another blitz by the linebackers. Here they come, Washington with the pickup. Now Bernie's on an island. Bernie's got to make this tackle to force the punt. That's what you do. You play with fire. Sometimes you get burned. That time Bernie held up strong on the outside and made the tackle.
So Andy Leffler comes on to punt to Norris Searcy. Searcy's back at the 12. This is a tail wagger that Searcy will fair catch at about the 19-yard line. So a 34-yard punt, no return. They've been playing this game a long time. This is the 100th meeting between NC State and North Carolina. Two schools separated by 20 miles. Back after a word from your local stations. ACC football is being brought to you in part by GMC. Gorgeous campus on a gorgeous day in the fall as we head into Thanksgiving week. As you look at the well, we're in the shadow of the bell. Stone walls nestled between the pines here in Kenan Stadium. Used to love to play in the stadium, partner, when I was up in College Park.
Just come up here and drop the hammer, did you?
Well, I don't know about that. I spent more time over at the well. Completion for Yates. Jones tiptoes his way across the 25. Nate Irvin made the stop.
Tim, throughout this game, we're going to see the team sprinkle in the run game, but as a supplement to the run game, you're going to see these screens to the outside, and that's where the linebackers are going to play huge dividends. Both these teams have linebackers that can run, and Nate Irvin is right there to make the play.
So to bring up second down and 4, certainly manageable. For T.J. Yates at the 25. Yates play action. Has time. Now throws. Has it complete. Nelson breaks the tackle.
turns it loose. Elsie across midfield. It's a foot race. Elsie all the way down to the 25-yard line. Finally tracked down by David Emerson. A gain of 51 yards.
We mentioned the fact that T.J. Yates comes in tied for last and sacks given up. He gets some pressure here, but does a great job at finding Elsie underneath. Elsie steps out of the tackle right there and does an outstanding job of getting up the field until he just ran out of gas. But a good job of Elsie. We talked about Elsie over 100 yards receiving last week against Virginia Tech.
He accounted for 184 yards last week, but did have a huge fumble at the goal line. First down, Yates has pressure. He's got to go, and he'll be sacked all the way back to the 38-yard line. David Akini came in and made the play.
Boy, this one's going to be on TJ because they had a screen set up to the left side. You're going to see Elsie slip left. They want to throw a screen out there, and that's why NC State's got so many hats back around the quarterback. And you can see TJ kind of pound on the ball. 30 sacks, second in the ACC is NC State, but TJ upset with himself that he didn't throw that one away.
And what a huge play with North Carolina in great field position. They lose 13. Second and 23. Little screen pass to Elsie. Elsie still on his feet inside the 20 to the 15-yard line. Honey Cole knocked him out, but a terrific play by Anthony Elsie. 20 yards.
They got right back to it. A little token play fake. And then they throw the screen to the left side. This is the play they wanted to get to just a play ago. Excellent job executing this time by T.J. Yates. And Elsie has been a huge factor here in the first quarter.
Elsie started last week because of the injury to Johnny White, the broken clavicle. And off to a good start here. 5'10", 205-pound senior. One of the 17 honored here today on Senior Day. Carolina needs three on third down. Elsie again, big hole inside the 10. Anthony Elsie. A gain of 8. It'll be first and goal, Carolina.
They get a great block on the inside. It looked like maybe Ingersoll falls back to the inside of the tackle spot. It gets Irving picked up. And a good job by Elsie getting downhill. And how about the call? John Shoup goes to the run on third and three and sticks it in there for a first down.
Elsie so far letting his eyes move his feet. He's found some holes that didn't even look like they were there. NC State defensively has been outstanding in the red zone this year.
Tim, this bunch look can cause problems. Now they'll motion in and out of it. They'll run man coverage routes out of it.
Curtis Bird went to the top of your screen in motion. Yates with plenty of time. Underneath Elsie, touchdown, North Carolina.
Elsie right here. What he's going to do is he's going to delay, and then he's just going to come right here on a check down. Little delay, then just check down in the hole, and Yates is right on the money with the throw.
Casey Barth for the extra point, splits the sticks. And the University of North Carolina strikes first in this great rivalry in 7-0 Tar Heels. Yates loves it. 4:34 to play in the first quarter. There's no doubt that fans are still hot for bow time, and there's no better time to enjoy the Bojangles tailgate special of 8 pieces of seasoned chicken, 4 made from scratch biscuits, 2 large fixins, and a half gallon of their legendary iced tea. Remember, it's always bow time when you're tailgating. Spectacular day. T.J. Yates off to a quick start, has his team on the board 7-0. Now we'll see if NC State can answer. Graham will come up and take it. Actually, it'll be taken before Graham at the 18-yard line. While they change possessions, get your cell phones ready. It's time for the AT&T fan vote. We want your answer to this question. Well, this one should be easy, don't you think? Text your answer to A1 or A2 to 55333 or go to theacc.com and vote. You'll get the results in the second half. I'm guessing that one may be split right down the middle.
I would think so.
Kelsey on that drive, 3 catches, 79 yards in the touchdown. Ran it one time for 8 yards. Now we'll see if NC State can answer. This is Washington to the 25-yard line. James Washington, he was injured in the preseason camp, is having a nice year. 6 foot, 180-pound sophomore, stopped by Price. Gain of 6.
Yeah, Jabari Price, the true freshman on the corner, number 4 from Pompano Beach, Florida. Jabari, just his second career start. Did an outstanding job on the outside. He's teamed up back there with 3 seniors, so he's on the job learning.
Those seniors have never beaten NC State. The Wolfpack going for their 4th straight win over Carolina. This ball thrown incomplete. Davis had a chance. Well thrown ball by Wilson. And Price, the freshman, was right there to defend it.
And how about this might be the reason he's on the field. This is outstanding coverage. Fade down the right sideline. And look at Jabari Price look back for the football in time when he's going to get the hands in to get the strip. Outstanding job by the freshman on the corner.
Price posted it, stayed right in his hip pocket. NC State 1 for 3 on 3rd down conversions. They need 3 on this play.
They've been showing pressure looks in this situation so far. They play zone.
Wilson looks deep, has a man, and it's overthrown. Oh, my. Jay Smith had come open down the sideline, and a strike would have gotten him 6.
Yeah, and Kendrick Burney and Deontay Williams are talking to each other. Burney, for some reason, got caught to the inside on the seam route and was beat. And Russell just didn't put enough air under the ball. Boy, he's been outstanding on deep throws. Just didn't have enough trajectory for Smith to run underneath that one.
Wilson's made a strong case for player of the year. 4-time ACC player of the week, but he let that one back. Leffler's punt is a low liner. Taken at the 33 and taken down immediately. 43-yard punt, a return of 4. Well, Champion presents How You Play, and one of the greatest college football players of all time, Charlie Choo Choo Justice, had a bronze statue unveiled in his honor 6 years ago near the west entrance of this stadium. College Football Hall of Famer was a star back for the Tar Heels in the 40s and was twice the runner-up for the Heisman Trophy. The statue is a great tribute to one of the most beloved figures in the history of this school. And that's our Champion feature, celebrating the history and traditions of ACC football. The ACC Champion, it's How You Play. Had a great career with the Washington Redskins. Charlie Choo Choo Justice. Yates over the middle has another completion. T.J. Yates off to a good start. Ryan Taylor just short of the first down. Brandon Bishop made the tackle.
Just his second catch on the year. I don't think you could say enough about what T.J. Yates has done this year. Zach Pianalto out for the season, his top receiver. He loses Johnny White, his top rusher. Greg Little, his top receiver from a year ago, is ineligible. He's done an outstanding job with different guys being plugged into the system, completing 65% of his passes. And when he's done here at North Carolina, will hold virtually every passing record.
Drone and bird to your eyebacks. Yates having none of it. He'll tuck it and run and be close to the first down, depending on the mark. How about Yates? 9 for 9, 125 yards. What a start.
Now you look at the numbers, it's phenomenal what he's been able to do. Now he's played a lot of games, 42nd career start today. But he has seen the highs and lows. You talk about what he's been able to accomplish in his career. You see the numbers. John Shoup, the offensive coordinator, says he has seen the highs and the lows that it takes to play quarterback at a big-time operation like North Carolina. And he's come out on the other side, and he's looked pretty good his senior year.
So Carolina gets the first and on first down. Absolutely nowhere to run for Sean Drone. That's a loss of 1. Well, you're a quarterback, Arch. Tell me about the character of a kid who comes back from throwing 4 picks and starts off the next game, a rival game, 9 for 9.
Well, I think it completely epitomizes what John Shoup was talking about. The grittiness is Barnum, the tight end, who's made 2 catches already today, still down on the field. But TJ's ability to weather the storm, if you will. There's been some booing here. He's been treated
poorly. He's been cheered. He's been there's been accolades thrown his way through the 4 years he's been here. But he's weathered the storm, and he's been the one guy that they've kind of hang their hat on all year long after everything they've gone through this year. T.J. Yates has been the guy standing there. Two 400-yard days for T.J. Yates on the year against LSU and Florida State.
You know, a lot of the experts thought that Butch in his fourth year would return to the top 10 for the first time since Mack Brown was here. But then, of course, the investigation took place, and this is what they're missing. And not only injuries, but the investigation. And certainly when they went to play LSU with kids off the bench, it was like going bear hunting with a stick.
It was, and the effect it had on the team is the players that you expected to be playing special teams roles and being your core special teamers are now all of a sudden playing on offense and defense, so you got to find other guys to play special teams as well, and they became thin in that area, and they had to fight through that all year long. But it's really a credit to the coaching staff to keep this team ready to play each and every week with so many players out.
NC State's defense has to bow its back here. Second down and 10. They've got to start changing the tempo of this game. Again, thrown over the middle. Highsmith has it. It's complete for the gain of 8, but oh, did T.J. Yates take a shot?
Well, Highsmith continues to work now, the sophomore wide receiver. Now, T.J. looking, he's to about his fourth option here. Takes a big lick on the back end, but a good job by Highsmith to continue to slide in the zone coverage and present his numbers to his quarterback so T.J. had a place to throw the football. Good job of working by the sophomore wide receiver.
But for NC State, they finally got T.J. Yates' attention. They have to make him uncomfortable in that pocket back there. Chase him out and let him hit the ground once or twice to change the momentum. Here they give it to Drone. Drone has another first down, down to the 40-yard line. Michael Lemon will get credit for the tackle.
Take a look at the Geico scoreboard. Number of big games today. But how about the North Carolina two times now on third and in a situation where you think maybe you might throw the football, running the football. And now as a defensive coordinator, you got to rethink things a little bit about how you're going to attack maybe the passer, and all of a sudden here comes the run game at you.
You're right, but with this start with by Yates, I'm guessing Mike Archer's going to dial it up a little bit. Stuff going after him. Again, they throw underneath. They found a little something against NC State. Adams makes the catch this time. They keep going under. Little safe passes, pick up a 5.
Well, North Carolina, very well schooled in whoever they have in the game, it's a pass catcher, at finding the holes and hooking up in the holes for T.J. Yates to throw the football. They want to get the ball out of his hands quickly, but North Carolina State's got a good job of taking away his first option. But because the offensive line is playing at a pretty high level right now, he's been able to hold on to it and find his secondary throw.
State held Wake Forest to just 188 yards of total offense. They're trying to find the defense now and change things here. 145 yards already in this game.
False start. Offense, number 66. 5-yard penalty. Remains second down.
Let's go downstairs to Mike.
Yeah, good news for North Carolina. Ed Barham twisted that left ankle, but he's retaping it, and they think he'll be back, so he is probable to return.
Well, the key there, Mike, and as you well know, Barham is an outstanding edge blocker. Mike doesn't have quite the pass-catching skills as a Zach Pianalto, but he's an outstanding edge blocker in the run game. Need to get him back on the field.
Zach Pianalto broke his leg. He's out. Barham's in, as Arch says, and that'll be the end of the first 15. So the first quarter comes to an end. Carolina's got the edge. NC State starting to make Yates a little uncomfortable. It's 7-0 Tar Heels. North Carolina up on NC State 7-0. Anthony Elzy, 7-yard pass from T.J. Yates. That's the only scoring we have in this great rivalry. Today being played in Chapel Hill. Story so far, T.J. Yates has hit all 11 passes, 11 for 11, 139 yards. This is second down and 10 from the 40. Yates again. Throws, has a man, and overthrows him, his first incompletion. And Dwight Jones had gotten behind him. And T.J. Yates, slow to get up.
Yeah, digging himself up off the ground. Here's your number right here. Wow, how about this right here? In time of possession, outstanding job.
Pep Boy first quarter stats. Our first quarter stats presented by Pep Boy.
So it'll bring up third down and 10 coming off that incompletion. Across that NC State front now. Wholesale changes. Lemon, Kuhn, Slay, Augustine. Augustine in the ballgame now. Yates has to get chased out of the pocket. Throws, and that's incomplete. Two in a row now. Good pressure by the defense.
Twice he tried to get the ball to Dwight Jones. We talked about Dwight Jones, number 83. He's had some big-time hookups with the junior wide receiver, but missed him twice there, and now going to be forced to punt from really good field position.
It was only a matter of time before this NC State defense really kind of bowed its back. Bryn Renner now in the ball game. Renner's your punter. This is a low knuckleball that's taken at the 13-yard line. Time to update you on our AT&T fan vote. We asked you this question: which coach, who do you want to win this game? You see the current voting percentages on the screen. There's still time to participate. Text your answer A1 or A2 to 55333 or go to acc.com and vote. We'll give you the results in the second half. NC State out of the gates. Fans are active.
Tom O'Brien now is going to look for some positive, something positive on first down. He's got to get the ball rolling. So he's got to find a way to be a little bit more positive on first down. North Carolina's done a good job of limiting what NC State's been able to do.
This is the ACC's leading pass attempt. They give the ball straight ahead. And Mustafa Green gets a
number 33, Mustafa Green,
few tough yards, a pickup of three.
Well, these are two teams in NC State and North Carolina that kind of sprinkle the run in. They'd like to run it. Every team wants to, but they're 9th and 10th in the ACC running the football. So it's been more of a mix-up for their two quarterbacks to get it done. Russell Wilson is where this engine goes. He does a great job of sorting things out secondary-wise.
No question about that. Wilson rolls to the right. Dangerous with his legs. Throws a pass underhanded. Has it complete. It'll be 2 yards short of the first. Nice job by Wilson to get the ball to Taylor Gentry. Almost throws this underhanded.
Yeah, how about the two quarterbacks, though, Tim? We talked about it from the top. They were going to be the featured guys. But finding a way to get the ball moved. Here, just a little underarm flip. Pass Sturdivant. Gets the ball to Gentry. Gentry gets up the field. And now you're third and short simply because Russell Wilson used his head there. Did a great job escaping, extending the play, and finding some way to get the football to.
He is spectacular. He's a creator. He's an outstanding quarterback. And they're hoping he comes back for another year at NC State. Straight ahead they go. It'll be close to the first down. State's got it. Move the chains. They needed one. They got three.
I've been impressed with both teams using their ground attack to offset what they do in the passing game. We've seen North Carolina run it on two third down plays when it might be a passing situation there, albeit third and a long one. They go ahead and turn it over. NC State runs the football for a first down. So both John Shute and Dana Bible right there are finding ways to keep their ground attack a part of the mix.
Mustafa Green back into the ball game. Wilson steps up and goes to Green. Green with a strong stiff arm, a first down, and that gets NC State fired up on the sidelines. Sturdivant and Price finally get him out of bounds. What a finish to this run.
Wow, this is an impressive kid now. This is a kid that's going to be around a long time. Just a freshman, catches the ball out of the backfield. That's his 26th reception on the year. But he finishes runs. Whether it's a reception or whether it's handed to him, he finishes.
You know, partner, that's a statistic that should be kept. Yaks, yards after contact, because this kid always ends up getting two or three more after the first man hits him. First and 10. Wilson slides. It's about eight. Let's go downstairs to Mike Hogwood. Michael?
Well, it was senior day here for North Carolina. It was senior day last week for NC State. And you can see Russell Wilson walking out on the field with his family. He gave them each a bracelet in memory of his dad. Now, remember, he's only a junior. He could come back next year, but he has signed a baseball contract to the Colorado Rockies. He's meant so much to NC State, they wanted to honor him just in case he doesn't come back.
And Wilson hands it off to Green. He's got the first down And NC State's got a good drive going here. You know, Mike, talking about Russell Wilson, I'm not sure, and I've heard from several different people, that Russell Wilson wants to play in the National Football League. That is his dream.
Well, when you start looking at what this kid has done in just 3 years of playing quarterback, he's making a case for himself that he should be playing at the next level. He's an intelligent kid. He's already has his degree. He's working on another degree. The kid is off the charts intelligent. His preparation is what Dana Bible points to, is what's taken him to the next level as a quarterback. He just does not leave a page unturned in his preparation for a game.
Well, Deion Sanders knocked the door down. He played both football and basketball. Played both in one day. Here's a long pass. They've got a man open, and it's complete inside the five to Owen Spencer. No flags. Wilson threw that pass where Spencer could go and get it. Gain of 48 yards.
This is one where I don't think Jabari Price realized the quarterback could throw it this far. How about this arm strength now? On the dead run, threw this about 50 yards in the air. Wilson does a great job adjusting the football. There is a flag down on the field, but how about the adjustment of Owen Spencer?
The flag came after the play. It's unnecessary roughness against Carolina, and it brought Tom O'Brien out onto the field. About as animated as I've seen Obi in a long time. And now he goes back and assumes the position. But he was out on the field, and he was chirping about that play. Got the flag, and now it's first and goal for NC State.
Boy, how about the display of arm strength by Russell Wilson there on the dead run? Good job of mixing it up. Yeah, been a good job of mixing it up.
NC State. Green. Not a whole lot there. Copels, Powell, and Page Moss made the tackle.
Well, this is where you become so dangerous as an offense when you have a guy like Russell Wilson. We talked about Russell Wilson has 6 touchdowns rushing in just the last 4 games. And this is the area where he devastated Florida State with his ability to pull it down and put it in the end zone himself.
NC State loves the play action and then throw to Green. Not this time. They go inside. Touchdown, Davis. NC State on the board. Darryl Davis.
Just a simple flat slant combination. Outside was Davis. Davis runs the slant to the inside, and just a beautiful throw inside the safety. But the flat held the corner wide enough where he had the little hole in there, and Wilson shoves it in the end zone for his 23rd touchdown on the year.
And Joukowsky, who was said to be out for the season with that hamstring injury, is on for the extra point. Josh Joukowsky, and this game is tied. Make no mistake about it, Russell Wilson has been spectacular. He's thrown underhand, sidearm, and across his body, and he's zipped this pass in. 4 for 4 on that drive, 67 yards and a touchdown. You are watching the ACC Football Network, an exclusive production of Raycom Sports. Glad to have you along on a spectacular day. Russell Wilson 4 for 4 on that drive, and NC State comes roaring back to make it a tied game at 7 apiece. Merletti and Harrelson are deep for Carolina. This is Harrelson to the 28-yard line.
Ball returned by number 82.
Tim, we've had high-level quarterback play so far today. These two guys have really put it on. And a good job of T.J. Yates finding Elsley. Elsley has done a nice job of getting open for him underneath. And of course, it ended with a little touchdown pass. Put North Carolina on the board to start off. But these two quarterbacks have been outstanding. He had his first 11 throws and then 2 incompletions the last time North Carolina had the ball.
Now for NC State, the Wolfpack wants to pick up where they left off. They made him a little uncomfortable in the pocket, and they changed things with those 2 incompletions. First down and 10, Tar Heels. Straight ahead, lost the 30, still on his feet to the 35-yard line. Anthony Elzey bullying his way Gain of eight.
It's a good job of keeping the legs churning. Then you get the offensive line giving you a little push. You get your wide receiver Dwight Jones in there, number 83, giving a little push. And when you run the football successfully, it's everybody with a blue hat on or a white hat on who's running it, pushing and getting on your man. Right now, North Carolina moving it pretty good on the ground.
Second down and two. And this time he's going to lose yardage. Manning came through and tattooed him for a loss of five.
Boy, these three linebackers for North Carolina State are unbelievable. This one's Terrell Manning. Manning comes, it's his eighth tackle for loss on the year, but they just do an outstanding job of reading, reacting, and then they close. They don't just see it. They have the ability to close in no time to make the play.
And they get there with bad intentions. Carolina, 2 of 4 third down conversions this afternoon. They need 7 here. Yates with time, throws underneath again. It'll be close to a first down, but I don't think he made it. Highsmith tried to lunge ahead. Wolf made a good stop.
Again, working that underneath zone coverage. We saw this completed earlier to Highsmith. This time a good job of getting him on the ground by Earl Wolf, the safety.
Wolf, that sophomore, coach has told us he's a run support guy and probably one of the best open field tacklers they have on defense.
Yeah, number 2 on their team in tackles.
Well, how about this? Fourth down and 1, and Carolina's going for it. It's a sore subject around these parts for the guys in white, and now T.J. Yates calls timeout.
A lot of discipline up front by North Carolina State to hang in there.
Timeout on the field. We'll take one as well. Back after this from your local stations. Closed captioning for ACC football is brought to you in part by Bojangles Famous Chicken and Biscuits. It's bow time. I want to know why those two aren't in the stadium. There are more people in this stadium today than live in Chapel Hill, North Carolina. C.J. Fiegels to punt. Graham is back at the 25. This is a long punt that takes him back to the 15-yard line. Graham gets a block. There is a flag. All the way up to the 33-yard line, but I think this is going to come back for a block in the back. 44-yard kick and a 15-yard return.
Well, really surprising. The back judge was standing right there. He didn't throw the flag. It came all the way in from the sideline on this
during
illegal
return,
block.
Illegal block in the back. Number 22 of the receiving team. Half the distance. First down.
So North Carolina now with 2 penalties, and or NC State rather, and the Wolfpack leads the ACC in fewest yards penalized, only 36 a game.
Well, how about Russell Wilson? How about him finding different ways to beat you? Now, let's watch this. He doesn't do the same thing twice. Through the little flat pass, he runs with it. Now he skates out of the pocket and puts one of his big receivers up the bat, and now the timing throw for the touchdown. Russell Wilson will find a way, and he'll find your weakness, and he'll beat you.
NC State's a team that gains momentum as the game goes on. They had 1 first down in the first quarter, had 5 on the last drive. Russell Wilson is your quarterback. First down. Tough yards by James Washington. Paige Moss makes the tackle after a gain of 4.
A real good job there that time by number 98, Dante Paige Moss. Because he's caught in no man's land there. He's got to try to defend Washington and defend the quarterback Wilson. Did a pretty good job of taking away Wilson running it and then folding back in to make the tackle.
Now NC State has to take care of business today, and if they should get the win here, they will all be firmly focused on College Park tonight, watching Florida State and Maryland. Russell picks up a block, picks up another, gets close to the first down, puts his arm across the line and has the first, I believe, a gain of 7.
Well, because he's done such a good job of scrambling, watch Darrell Davis, number 15, peel back here and get Bernie, this corner, on the block right there. Outstanding block. It allowed Wilson to extend the play a little further and get up the field for the first down.
A very heady player extends his arm with the football across the 20-yard line. So that's where the ball is marked. First down and 10 at the 20. Wilson needed only 37 rushing yards to go over 1,000 for his career today. Wilson again has the outside, throws, it's complete to Bryan. Bryan breaks a tackle and has a first down for NC State. Pickup of 12.
So this is going to seem like something slight, but watch him shoot this football. It's not a lob. He realizes it's tight coverage. If he gets the ball to Bryan on the move, Brian's going to be able to get some run after the catch. Had he lobbed that, he brings the defender into play to make a tackle at the point of catch. But because he shoots it in there, allows Bryan to catch it and turn up the field.
So a new set of downs for Wilson. Again, he rolls and throws deep. A lot of bumping and grinding going on. No flags, and the ball is overthrown. It was intended for Jarvis Williams. Let's go downstairs to Mike.
Well, at running back today is James Washington. He moved into the starting lineup a couple of weeks ago. Out last year with a knee injury, was slow recovering. He's the guy that they wanted in the backfield. They've been going with two freshmen, Mustafa Green and Dean Haynes. But Tom O'Brien told us this week he likes what Washington gives him. He knows all the protections, and he has outstanding speed.
He's a receiver that comes in the last two games, has 11 receptions for Russell Wilson.
Today he's got three carries, 15 yards. They're looking for Washington here, but I don't think you're going to get it. Picked off by North Carolina. Terrific coverage by Searcy, who was in inside out all the way. His fourth interception of the year.
Now Searcy steps up the line of scrimmage. Number 21, he's got Washington in man coverage. Does an outstanding job of keeping inside leverage and makes a great play. He led the team in interceptions coming in. That's his fourth on the year. What a good job of playing the ball.
Searcy missed the first three games of the season because of the NCAA investigation. Since that time, he's got four interceptions. Carolina now with good field position. Yates steps up, throws underneath, has it complete. This is Taylor. Taylor rolls down inside the 25.
Tim, I love the way North Carolina's tight ends and H-backs work. I mean, we talked about Zach Pianalto being out. He was the leader receiver. He was their tight end. Now here comes Taylor, another tight end, another guy that has the ability to read coverage, break off the linebackers or a safety, and get to the inside.
Carolina statisticians were trying to jump the gun here, but that play does officially take T.J. Yates over the UNC record for most passing yards in the season. He broke his own mark. Off to a terrific start here today. First down and 10 Tar Heels. Here's the give to Elzey. He's got space. And Elzey still on his feet inside the 20. Okay. Nate Irvin throws him down after a gain of 6.
Isn't it amazing how quickly the hole closes, though? Elzey looked like he had a lot of room to run, and all of a sudden, here come the linebackers, Irving and Manning, and you're limited to a 3 or 4 yard gain. What looks like a huge hole closes quickly with these NC State linebackers.
Nate Irvin is some kind of linebacker. He definitely knows the difference between come here and sick 'em. Second down. Yates out of the gun. High snap. This is Jones. Nice play defensively. And again, it's Nate Irvin playing sideline to sideline.
You can't hesitate with these linebackers. If you have the get up field, now here catches the ball. Jones catches the ball on the outside. Now, this is outside the numbers. The guy that just made the play was standing between the hash marks when the ball was snapped. That's how quickly Nate Irvin goes from sideline to sideline. Outstanding seek and destroy linebacker.
There have been a lot of great defensive players in this league. A couple of them from right here. Julius Peppers, of course. Lawrence Taylor. Well, he's a good one, isn't he? Nate Irvin. Down to the 10-yard line. Anthony Elzey.
Reach into the bag of tricks here, Johnson. Reach into the bag of tricks. Makes it look like T.J. Yates is checking to the sideline for a play, and they
direct snap. Now he's going to look back like he's getting some instructions. He's still calling the snap count, and they direct snap it to Elzy, who goes straight ahead to pick up the first down on third and short. Little trickery there.
NC State takes a timeout. Tom O'Brien wants to have a little word. One of the all-time rivalries in the Atlantic Coast Conference, NC State and North Carolina. They sure wish they had some of these guys, especially at running back. And last year's starting running back, Sean Drone, is out. Johnny White, this year's running back, is out. Get Bonnie Bernard, Ryan Houston, all out. Elzy carries here.
I think Anthony Elzy is filling in admirably here at the running back spot. Not only is he running, he's catching the ball out of the backfield. They're an outstanding job.
Gain of one, stopped by Wolf. That just shows the depth they have here. They just reload.
Yeah, they've really done a great job of recruiting here. Both these teams have done a great job of recruiting in really the same recruiting area.
Earl Wolf is down on the sidelines down here.
Big time player right there.
He's okay. He is their run support guy and the second leading tackler on this Wolfpack defense.
Look for 27, Earl Wolf threw the arm out there and might have taken a shot from his own man. Manning coming in, number 35. Kind of hit him up in the headgear there. Maybe you throw the arm out. Tim, you made a lot of tackles back in your day. A lot of throw that arm out there, that shoulder gets exposed.
Yeah, but when I was at Maryland, we played in so many homecomings, we took our own floats. Haviland with Deposit Shield, giving you a chance to win a VIP trip to the Meineke Car Care Bowl. Gas for a year and other great prizes. Text MCCB1 to 64718 or visit Haviland.com. The Meineke Car Care Bowl. And Wolf appears to be okay.
That's been a good bowl here the last several years, too, that Meineke Car Care Bowl. There's been a lot of great games in it.
Now, coming up next week on the ACC Football Network, next Saturday at noon, we'll be on the air. But we're not sure where we're going yet. The game will be announced tomorrow on the ACC.com. We're waiting to see what shakes out here today, see how the races develop, and see what teams win, what teams lose. Big, big weekend. NC State in a monster game here, trying to keep their Atlantic Division title hopes alive. Second down for the Tar Heels. Yates out of the gun, again has pressure. Yates escapes, rolls left. And Yates throws it away. Big time play by a fifth year senior.
That's it's a great decision by TJ. He does a good job extending the play, but excellent pressure to the inside. Really, NC State should have had the sack maybe right there. But TJ extends the play. Sweezy was all around his legs, but couldn't get him on the ground. And then TJ makes a good decision, fires it out of bounds.
Dave Archer, you were a big-time quarterback. Some of your best passes for a quarterback are incompletions, are they not?
Well, no question about it. Decision-making is one of the process that a quarterback has to go through more, trying to find out how to play this game. Not just throwing it, finding a way to make sure that you throw the football in the right spots. We got a tight one here in Chapel Hill.
On the left, John Shoup. On the right,
Mike Archer.
Mike Archer, defensive coordinator. Matching wits here on third down for the Tar Heels. They swing it out to the 10. Elzy inside the 5. Reaches for the goal line, but will come up 2 yards short.
Defense is complete number 6.
C.J. Wilson knocked him out of bounds. A pickup of 7.
And again, a good job by NC State to kind of collapse the pocket around TJ, where he has to shoot it to the outside. And now it's Elzy one-on-one on the outside with Jones and or Wilson, I'm sorry, C.J. Wilson. And C.J.'s able to push Elzy out of bounds.
So on fourth down, Carolina will get the 3 and be happy with it. Casey Barth, 11 for 13 this year. And they're going to review the previous play. I think they're going to review it for the mark. He reached ahead. And they want to find out where that ball was with the extension of the arm.
Yeah, I agree with you, Tim. I think they're going to try to find out where, as Elzy reaches out with the football, He certainly, I don't think he got in, but he certainly is closer than the two. Does the foot step out of bounds?
Well, now this is going to be a decision because if he is down inside the one or close to the one, Carolina will take a look at this and may go. They are not against going for it on fourth and short.
I think if you're inside the one, you'll go. I think you'll see Butch Davis go for it inside the one. And I think you're going to see an adjustment of where the ball is placed here.
Certainly in a rival game, you want to use common sense, but you want to get points in bunches and not just settle for field goals. Butch Davis has a history of going for it on fourth down.
Well, let's maybe take a look at that one more time and see if he's able to get the nose of the football to the pylon. That's what you're looking for, is did he touch the pylon with the nose of the ball? That's certainly what he was trying to do. Watch the ball and watch the pylon. Does the pylon move as he extends the football?
No, I think from that angle it looks closer than it really is. I don't even think he was down to the one. And I'm not sure there's a video evidence of where that ball should exactly be placed. But I will tell you this, Carolina this year is 11 of 18 on fourth down, 61% conversion rate. Pretty strong. So the officials are taking a while with this as Tom O'Brien looks on. Brad Allen waiting for the call upstairs. Again, with wins today and next week, NC State will clinch the Atlantic Division title. It's been a tough November. Three of the final four games on the road. As you look at Carolina deciding where the ball will be and what they should do.
Hey, look at this November road trip that NC State has had to go on, Tim. They go back all the way back to 1973 when they won the ACC championship. Went 2-1 on the road in November, and that's what they're trying to repeat here in 2010.
Here's a little bit better angle.
I'll tell you what, he wasn't far away from the
pylon. He was closer than I thought. Yeah,
he's inside the one.
He is inside the one where that ball went out there.
I think if they get inside the one, Butch is going to go for this.
I agree with you.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. Fourth down. The game clock will start on the ready for play signal.
So the ball will stay where it was originally marked. And Casey Barth comes back out, the kicker. So he'll mark off his spot. Ball on the two. Officially a 19-yard field goal attempt, and it is good. So Casey Barth adds to the scoreboard, and Carolina takes the lead once again with 2:38 to play in the first half.
North Carolina took advantage of the short field, the interception by Searcy. They're able to move it down and put three on the board. And in these kind of games where you know it's going to be tight to the wire, you have to take advantage of the other team's mistakes.
Take a look at the ACC standings presented by Irwin Vice Grip. Irwin Vice Grip, groove lock pliers adjust with the press of a button and never lip or pinch. Virginia Tech, solid hold on the Coastal Division. 6-0, trying to get through unbeaten. Big game today against Miami.
Yeah, Miami needs some help there as you look at Virginia Tech. And what a story that is. How many times are we going to see Frank Beamer's team maybe stumble early in the year, the last couple seasons, where they stumble early? Remember last year, they stumbled early. They weren't able to regroup. Now, it kind of pushes them deep in the national picture, but they have a chance to do it again.
Now, it's going to seem unfair for me to say this, But Virginia Tech, actually at the beginning of the year, was carrying the entire reputation of the Atlantic Coast Conference. So it wasn't just a loss for Tech. The entire conference lost there.
Yeah.
And then Miami losing at Ohio State.
Florida State goes to Florida
State, goes to Oklahoma. Right. All of those things hurt the league and the perception of the ACC. Big hole, flag down. Out to the 37-yard line goes T.J. Graham, but there is a flag. A return of 35 yards. Flag is at about the 27-yard line.
Yeah, and it came on the opposite side of where the return took place.
Here's Brad Allen with the call.
During the return, illegal block in the back, number 43 of the kicking team. That penalty would be missed for 10 yards. First down.
Route 49 Records recording artist and hit songwriter Bridget Tatum opened our broadcast with Loud, the ACC football theme song for the 2010 season, which is included on her just-released self-titled album, which can be purchased on iTunes. The video celebrating the excitement of ACC football can be viewed on Bridget's website, and a ringtone for the song can also be purchased by texting Loud, L-O-U-D, to 26000. First down for the Wolfpack. Wilson looks right, throws a dart, has it complete to Spencer. First down, NC State.
Once again, North Carolina comes with their linebackers. It's man coverage on the outside. Just the turnout to the outside. Great timing from Wilson. Puts it right on the money. But you better, if you're going to come with pressure against Russell Wilson, you better get there and change his, where he's standing, his launch point. If you don't, he's going to hurt you down the field.
Gain of 17, and Wilson now throwing on time, in rhythm. Again, throws underneath. It's complete to Davis. And another flag comes in.
Norris Searcy got tangled up with Jarvis Williams. Again, man coverage in the secondary. They're challenging this receiver core, North Carolina State.
Kendrick Burney was the guy on the coverage. Davis used his body well to shield him and make
the
catch.
During the pass, holding number 43 of the defense against an eligible receiver. That's a 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
43 is Curtis Campbell. A reminder, coming up at halftime, we'll have analysis, highlights, stats, and a whole lot more for you. All coming up on the Hardee's Halftime Report with Mike Hogwood. Big-time football game on a beautiful afternoon in Chapel Hill, North Carolina. The Wolfpack is on the move, trailing 10-7. North Carolina scored first. Anthony Elzey, a 7-yard pass from T.J. Yates. T.J. Yates started 11 for 11. And Russell Wilson got in rhythm. He went 4 for 4 on his drive. Wolfpack answered, tied it at 7. And then the 19-yard field goal by Casey Barth. And it's a 10-7 game. Wilson on first down has trouble and throws it away. Smart play, threw it in the direction of George Bryan. Now the crowd wanted pass interference or intentional grounding.
Well, I think they have a case for a complaint here. I don't think Russell Wilson ever gets outside that tight end tackle area.
I don't think he had to. It was thrown in the area of George Bryan and it just went over his head. Now Butch Davis isn't buying that.
Went over his head, it hit the band director in the head. It's in the stands.
Wilson again, throws into the end zone, look out. Almost intercepted by Merletti, but another flag comes in.
Well, this is one where Russell Wilson can't finish. You see, he couldn't get his hand through the ball, so it hung in the air. Gave Merletti a chance to find the football, and he almost comes up with it.
Dante Page Moss offsides for Carolina. So Page Moss with a big mental mistake there.
Well, and Russell Wilson, again, the headiness of the quarterback, I think he realized he had a defensive lineman in the neutral zone free play, so he took a shot down the field.
Third penalty against North Carolina on this drive. Second down and five. Wilson's going down. Paige Moss was there and made up for the offsides. A loss of seven.
Well, we talked about how young this offensive line is. Four sophomores up front. This time, Andrew Wallace is going to get beat to the outside by Paige Moss. He's going to put Russell Wilson on the ground. And they've had a tough time protecting Russell Wilson. Some of that is because Russell tries to extend plays. But that time, Paige Moss wins and puts the quarterback on the ground.
So with 1:18 to play in the first half, timeout on the field. Paige Moss feeling it.
Interesting to see here now how North Carolina decides to come defensively with some pressure.
Our Polaris hardest working player of the week, Bruce Carter. 43 career starts, 206 career tackles. Had a great week.
Well, Bruce Carter has got an engine that does not stop. He's on go all the time. 13 tackles a year ago in this game against NC State. He had six tackles a week ago against Virginia Tech, but he is a difference maker.
He's also the captain of the defense. They're on their feet, third down and 13 for NC State. And again, Wilson has to throw it away. Paige Moss again.
Looked like NC State got mixed up in their protection scheme on the left side of their front. Paige Moss comes in untouched. What NC State did was they slid their protection to the right side and nobody stepped backside. Usually that's a back. To pick up the backside on Paige Moss, he's all over Wilson.
Dana Bible's going to have to start going to his side and coming at him. So Josh Chakowski comes on. They said he was out for the season with a hamstring, but he's on to attempt this field goal. 47 yards. It's long enough. It's good. Josh Chakowski from 47 has tied the game.
I think the handy's okay.
You know, before the game, he was out there, Dave. He was out there, and he was trying them from even longer than that. First, he came out and loosened up the hamstring, but watch this. This is from 50 yards and woefully short. He just hit the field goal from 47.
That adrenaline will start flowing a little bit when you get into a game and everything on the line for your team, but watch him drill this one now. And that was right down central, no doubt. He didn't even watch it go through the uprights.
And Chris Hawthorne now will come on for the kickoff.
And normally Juskowski will do your kickoff guy as well, but trying to minimize the wear and tear on the leg and let Hawthorne kick off.
Todd Harrelson and Matt Merletti will be deep. There's Hawthorne. He'll kick off for NC State. Terrific football game if you're just joining us. The 100th meeting between these two clubs, North Carolina and NC State. North Carolina State still very much in the hunt for the Atlantic Division title, but needs a win here and a win next week against Maryland. This is a high kick that will be short, taken by the up back, and Curtis Byrd is out to the 34-yard line. 9-yard return. Arch, take a look at that Atlantic Division race because this thing is still wide open.
Yeah, well, everybody plays each other, and it's Maryland and NC State that control their own destiny. Florida State has to have some help. Remember, Florida State lost to North Carolina State a couple of weeks ago. They still play Maryland. Obviously, the Maryland game today.
Maryland plays tonight at 8 o'clock, Byrd Stadium, College Park. Maryland Terrapins will be wearing camouflage uniforms, and the proceeds will be going to the Wounded Warriors. But they need to beat Florida State, and they need to stay at home next week against NC State. Tom O'Brien on the road today and next Saturday in Byrd Stadium. T.J. Yates steps up, has a man wide open. That's complete. Highsmith down inside the 40. Highsmith still on his feet at the 37-yard line.
Tim, you'd be hard-pressed to find a quarterback that has better anticipation than T.J. Yates in the country. He's going to hold this ball to the last possible moment, step up and shoot it in the hole on the deep in route. He's an outstanding deep ball thrower.
Yates again, out of the gun. Has it completed the 31. So let me ask you this. This is the guy they were booing at times last year. Had more interceptions than touchdowns. Does he get a shot at the league?
Absolutely. I think this guy will definitely get a shot at the league, and I think somebody will pick him.
T.J. Yates again. Ball's loose. And the whistle had blown. Boy. August had knocked it loose. T.J. Yates is slow getting up.
Well, they had exactly what they wanted. There's no way they're going to have to drag T.J. Yates off the field for him not to line up in this thing now. But they had exactly on what they wanted. North Carolina State came with pressure. Elsley had slipped in the right flat, and T.J. just couldn't get the ball up over the outside pressure. And it was batted away. Good job by Augustine to get the hands elevated to look like maybe it batted away.
But that's a hit that will get his attention, make him a little bit uncomfortable. Remember now, he started this game 11 for 11. They hit him once, hit him twice, and then he missed a couple. Let's see what happens this time. And he's hit again and throws incomplete.
That one he threw away because of good job by Amerson. The freshman corner squatted down on the route. He wanted to throw a quick throw to the outside to Dwight Jones, but Amerson, the corner, freshman corner, does an outstanding job of standing his ground, and T.J. threw the football away.
So NC State turned up the heat, made the stop. Casey Barth comes on for the field goal attempt. This will be from 49 yards, trying to answer Joukowsky's 47-yarder. Good snap, good hold. This one's long enough. And it's good. From 49 yards, Casey Barth gives the lead right back to the Tar Heels.
Oh, what a big kick. That's his season-long kick. Came in as long as 46 yards. And another one, no doubt.
I mean, he flat split the sticks. Casey Barth, 49-yard field goal. He's now 13 for 15 on the year.
We got a whole half left to play here, Tim, but it kind of gives you the feeling that whichever quarterback has the ball last, and if he's got a chance to win it, he's going to get it done.
Two defenses playing at a very high level today as well. So NC State will get the ball back with 15 seconds to play in the half. Casey Barth will kick off. And there's a look at T.J. Graham. Barth sets the ball and now prepares to kick. 15 seconds left. The first thing that NC State wants to do is make sure it holds on to the football. This is a little pooch kick. And Graham gets it. Graham's got some space if he can get a block on the corner. Turns the corner and runs out of bounds with 9 seconds left. I'm not sure T.J. knew that there was nobody else behind that contained man.
I'm not sure what Curtis Underwood was trying to do there either. T.J.'s coming up to try to catch the football, and Underwood did the, I'm going to take it. No, you take it. And Graham's able to get his hand. I think if they'd gotten a decent return there, then you go ahead and squeeze the trigger with one timeout left and give yourself a chance. But with 9 seconds here, I think you just kneel down.
Well, they certainly go to that formation. They go to the kneel down formation. That's what happens. Spencer was the safety valve back at the 15-yard line. It's a good old-fashioned backyard ball. It's everything we expected. The first half has been some kind of fun to watch. North Carolina 13, NC State 10. Let's go downstairs to Mike.
Thank you, Tim. Coach, your thoughts on this first half? Pretty good game we got going here.
Yeah, typical game. Typical State Carolina game. So we got 30 more minutes. Going to be a heck of another half.
Any big adjustments you feel this team needs to make here at halftime?
Yeah, certainly that last pass we gave up here at the end of the half. We got to figure out what they did there. You know, that's the one that hurt us for the last field goal.
Tom O'Brien headed to the locker room with his team. This rivalry is a big one. This is a great game so far. 13 to 10 here at the half.
ACC football is brought to you by your Carolina Ford dealers, by Carrabba's Italian Grill, by John Deere, and by Geico.
Hardee's presents the Hardee's Halftime Report. Try Hardee's new hand-breaded chicken tenders freshly prepared on the premises. And on a gorgeous fall afternoon, 13-10 our score, the 100th meeting between North Carolina and NC State. Everybody thought before the game it would be a great one. It has lived up to it so far. Should be one whale of a second half. I thought it interesting that both of these teams were able to score on their last possession. So both teams go into the locker room with a little bit of momentum. NC State by the passing of Russell Wilson, moving it down the field. There were a few penalties on this drive. Russell Wilson under some heavy pressure, and Josh Jankowski comes in for a 47-yard field goal. Remember, they thought he'd missed the season with that bad hamstring, but not so. Then North Carolina able to answer right back. The long pass, T.J. Yates under some big-time pressure as well, and Casey Barth nails a 49-yard field goal, and that makes our score 13-10. And again, I think that's just indicative of what we're going to see in the second half. Both teams answering, and you got to believe that both of these teams in the locker room right now feel pretty good about themselves and pretty good about their positions in this football game. Fans, we invite you to come along for the ride this year with the newest installments of ACC Road Trip powered by the John Deere Gator XUV. Host Tommy Kane has been all over ACC country this season. He washed a little laundry with the equipment staff at Clemson. He dressed up as Paul Revere and walked the Freedom Trail before the BC Notre Dame game. And he also took a trip in the Everglades and checked out the alligators before hanging out with the fans before Florida State beat Miami in South Florida. And he carried the bass drum for the Cavalier Marching Band in Charlottesville. And he was eating ribs, tailgating with Virginia Tech fans before their game against Georgia Tech. Check out all the scenes and enter for your chance to win a 2011 John Deere Gator XUV at theacc.com/roadtrip. Nobody having more fun than Tommy Kane in that road trip. Little campus run to get folks loosened up. That was early this morning before the game. Those folks, you better trust me, they're right here in Kenan Stadium for this one.
It's game time at Carrabba's Italian Grill, the best in Italian dining. Now, here's the best of the ACC.
Nick Minkin. Russell Wilson continues to lead the conference in passing, averaging over 281 yards a game. The state junior's thrown for over 300 yards in 7 of 10 games this season. Having a good first half here this afternoon. Leonard Hankerson leads the ACC in receiving yards. The Miami senior averaging almost 90 yards a game. He's caught 11 touchdown passes, which ties a Hurricane season record. And there's no change at the top of the tackles list. BC's Luke Kuechly at a career-high 20 against Duke last Saturday. He remains the nation's top tackler, averaging 14.6 a game. And that's the best of the ACC, presented by Carrabba's. Our score here at halftime, 13-10. North Carolina got on the board first. State is able to answer. And then both teams, in their final drives before the half, able to get field goals for a little bit of halftime momentum. Now, there are some other games going on. We'll check our scoreboard, our ING direct scoreboard. Virginia leading Boston College at the half. Georgia Tech, a field goal over Duke. That's first quarter. Third quarter now, Wisconsin all over Michigan, Oklahoma, Kansas State, and Kansas got a good game going. Michigan State losing to Purdue. Upset brewing there. Pittsburgh, South Florida are tied. Penn State a field goal over Indiana. West Virginia leading Louisville. South Carolina all over Troy. And Florida three touchdowns better than Appalachian State in the second quarter. Games today. Virginia, Boston College, they've got a great one going. Clemson and Wake Forest. Florida State, Maryland is the big one in the Atlantic Division. Duke, Georgia Tech, and Miami and Virginia Tech. The other games going on today. Well, we've been telling you over the last couple of weeks about fall championships happening in the ACC. Last week, it was the ACC Soccer Championship in Cary. Maryland and North Carolina were the two teams. And off a handball right there, Matt Castle and a penalty kick. The one goal for Maryland, that was it. Now, there's a red card on North Carolina. They had to play most of the match a man down.
But Maryland wins the ACC Soccer Championship last Sunday, beating North Carolina by a score of 1-0. Oh, and it's a great, gorgeous day today. Hey, fans of the ACC are able to stay connected with ACC Sports via their iPhone or iPod Touch with the all-new official ACC Sports app presented by Haviland. Download today for breaking news, video recaps, and real-time scoring of all ACC football and men's and women's basketball games. Visit theacc.com for more information or search ACC in the iTunes Store. For a limited time, the app remains a $1.99 bargain.
Did you know you can get great Carolina experiences?
Gorgeous day here today. The great setting here in Kenan Stadium and a great rivalry. 13-10 our score. We're back with more after this word from your local ACC station. It loud, so do we. She got us going to begin of the game and getting us going here as we get closer to the start of the third quarter. It has been a great game so far, and I think a game that has been well played by the two quarterbacks, TJ Yates and Russell Wilson. I want to go back upstairs now to Tim Brandt and Dave Archer. And guys, one thing I think was important that both teams scored on their final drives, so both teams are going to come out here in the third quarter feeling pretty good about themselves.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question about it, Mike. I think NC State goes to the house saying, hey, we're only three down, have not played very well.
Well, I think that both teams have kind of taken advantage of opportunities. North Carolina took advantage of the interception, got a field goal there. NC State got a good kickoff return and a penalty. They turned that into points. So they've done a good job of taking advantage of their opportunities. Defenses have played well on third down. I think these teams combined are 5 of 14 on third down. So good job of doing a good job in that
area. Let's take you back. Look at that first half, some of the highlights. North Carolina out of the blocks quickly, but they also put the ball on the ground twice, and that was not a good thing for the Tar Heels.
No, they got the ball to tight end a couple times, and Nate Irby, of course, that's what he does, is make plays, gets the ball out, but North Carolina comes right back. TJ Yates was outstanding in the first quarter, 11 for 11, takes him down, finds Elzy for the touchdown.
NC State came right back. Darryl Davis made the catch. Russell Wilson was 4 for 4 on that drive.
It's really shaping up as which quarterback is going to have the ball last. This was the one mistake in the game. The throw to the flat, trying to get it out there. Searcy gets the interception, and that provided the short field for North Carolina. North Carolina was unable to get in the end zone, but settled for three.
And then it did become a field goal kicking contest. At first, you had the 19-yarder, then the 47-yarder by Josh Jakowski.
Well, Jakowski was nursing the hamstring coming in, missed a few in pregame, but there was no doubt on that one as he drilled it. North Carolina comes right back with a couple of completions and is able to drill a season-long for Barth from 49 yards.
So we take a look at our GMC halftime statistics. They look like this. Time of possession in favor of the Tar Heels.
Now, North Carolina's controlled the football for the most part, been able to mix the run in a little bit. TJ Yates, the short passing attack, he's 17 to 22 for 210 and a touchdown in the first half.
Wilson, 9 of 18, 122 yards, a touchdown. Elzy, 92 yards in pass receiving, 25 yards on the ground, 127 total yards. An emotional day in Chapel Hill. 17 seniors playing their final home game here at Kenan Stadium.
ACC football is being brought to you by Progress Energy, by SunTrust, by Liberty Mutual Insurance, by your local Toyota dealers, and by Hardee's.
ACC football is brought to you in high definition by H.H. Gregg. You'll find the biggest selection at the lowest prices. H.H. Gregg, price and advice guaranteed.
Well, Butch Davis came out, the first one to see him. Mike Hogwood, what do you say, Mike?
Yeah, well, first of all, he said the most important thing is containing Russell Wilson. He thought they did a great job of putting pressure on him. He said he thought there might have been a couple intentional groundings, but he says they can't let Russell Wilson make a big play. That's the whole key to the rest of this game for Carolina.
All right, Mike, he was fired up about that, no question about it. Arch, take a look at the quarterback numbers. These guys pretty strong in the first half.
Yeah, both guys have directed their team. Obviously, TJ, a shorter passing attack, done a nice job of taking care of the football. Russell made one mistake, but there's a number of great players in this game. And these two linebackers, Nate Irving, first of all, for NC State, gets the strip. He's all over the field here on a screen, comes from inside out to make the play. He is everywhere. There's another screen where Nate Irving, who lined up inside the hash marks, comes out and makes the play. But tell you what, there's another guy on the other side of the field that's all over the place too. Bruce Carter elevates there, bats the football away. Here he comes on a blitz. Puts Russell Wilson on the ground, and now he's going to drop into coverage. Come up and make a play. These two linebackers are everywhere.
Carter runs a sub 4.440, has a vertical leap of 40 and a half inches, and bench presses the world. Casey Barth kicks off. TJ Graham is deep. Graham will take it at the 16-yard line, and there's not a lot of room to run anywhere. So NC State will start. And again, Russell Wilson comes in after a 6-yard return by Graham.
That's a nice strategy that North Carolina has put in place here on special teams. It kind of goes by the wayside. You'll think of it as a short return, but they're doing a pop-up kick around the 20. It doesn't allow NC State to set up any of the returns, and then they cover and make the tackle for a minimal return.
Talking to NC State folks at halftime, they think their special teams have been a little bit under par today. So they want to see some improvement out of their special teams. Russell Wilson, first down for the Wolfpack. Give it to Washington. Washington looks for a couple of tough yards out to the 25-yard line. Dietrich Powell made the tackle.
There's not much there on first. Interesting, Tom O'Brien talked about, Butch Davis talked about trying to contain Russell Wilson. His defense has done a good job of shoving Russell to the sideline. They'd obviously like to shove him to his offhand, but trying to push him to make him lose ground to the sideline. They have not allowed him to escape straight ahead. Russell's had outstanding ability to escape inside the tackles this season.
Jarvis Williams at the top of the screen, twins down the lower. Russell then now throws to the top. He's got the first down to Spencer, and Spencer has good yardage, but there is a flag down on the play.
Holding, offense number 70. 10-yard penalty. Second down.
Jake Vermiglio is the guilty party. He's a 4-year starter, a 6'5", 325-pound senior.
Yeah, working against Paige Moss right here. Paige Moss, of course, was a monster in the first half, and Vermiglio got hold of the jersey there as Wilson escaped to the inside. So even though you don't get a sack or push the quarterback out of the pocket, you're affecting the football game if they're having to grab you and hold on to you to keep you from getting there. Paige Moss really has stepped it up, has played a high level today.
I'm still surprised they aren't running at him. They're running away from him and having all kinds of problems. Go with him, he'll have to go stationary to make a play. Second down and 18 for Wilson. Has time, throws deep, and it's incomplete. It was intended for Jarvis Williams, just overthrown. Good coverage by Denora Searcy.
The plan for North Carolina is very plain. They're going to come with pressure, and they're going to play man-to-man in the secondary. And see George Bryan, the tight end, dragging across the middle. He wants Russell to look his way. Felt like he was open to the inside, and there was nobody there. That's man coverage in the secondary.
And then Mackey semifinalists will let them know in the huddle, too. State just 2-for-6 in third down conversions. They need 18. They're on their feet in Kenan. Wilson, ball on the ground. They'll have to punt it. Allen got on it. Copel's knocked it loose. Wilson lost the handle.
This is one that'll really disturb Tom O'Brien. This is a three-man rush. Wilson gets sacked. by Copels on the three-man pass rush, and that's, as an offensive lineman, that's a black eye now. You can't allow that to happen as North Carolina dropped eight into coverage.
Yeah, and as a
because of that loss of seven, Leffler now will be punting halfway through the end zone. Searcy will have great field position standing at midfield. Low snap, low kick. He'll take this one on the run. Look for some help. Pretty good coverage by NC State. But they'll have great field position at the 39-yard line. A 40-yard punt, a 10-yard return. Want to see highlights of today's game? Just check out the Haviland ACC football highlights. They're now online. Each week you can view action from ACC Network telecast and other archived video. Log on to the ACC.com for these clips and a whole lot more from around the Atlantic Coast Conference.
Big challenge now for NC State's defense. Another short field. They've got to defend from their own 39-yard line and try to keep T.J. Yates and the Tar Heels out of the end zone.
Sean Drone is the running back now. Yates will throw on first. Yates will be hit, and he'll lose yardage. Second sack of the afternoon. Yates goes down. Irving was there again. He got help from Sweezy.
Give credit to the linebackers here for North Carolina State. They really muddied the look up for T.J. Yates to let this one go. He had a little high-low working with the tight end and the slot receiver, and the NC State linebackers did a good job. There's those three linebackers, boy. They flat getting after people.
Yeah, but that one was all on 6'5 junior J.R. Sweezy. Little swing pass out to Drone. Still short of the original line of scrimmage. David Emerson, the true freshman, takes him down after a gain of two. Top of Boston College as we take you around the Atlantic Coast Conference throughout the country. We'll keep you updated on all the scores. Don't forget now, Maryland plays at home tonight against Florida State, a game which has championship implications, and NC State will be watching that very closely. But they've got to take care of business here, and Carolina's giving them all they can handle. Play action for Yates. Steps up, he's got problems. Yates, little shuffle pass underneath. Drone, not going to get a first down. David Emerson again makes the tackle.
But it's a huge play, Tim, now, because now you have the ability to go for it on fourth down if you decide to. If he gets sacked here, it's a punting situation. Great job of TJ realizing his check down was right there and getting the ball to Drone, and now you can go for it on fourth down.
Was his knee down when he gave that little shuffle pass? It was close. They need four on fourth down. Yates, three-step drop, throws, has the first. To the 25-yard line goes Ryan Taylor.
Now, these are the routes that Zach Pianalto ran for T.J. Yates, and we talked to him yesterday about the comfort zone of him and Pianalto. Taylor taking that spot, more of an H-back than a tight end for Butch Davis. Does an outstanding job of catching the ball on the back hip and extending the drive.
Ryan Taylor came into this game with 16 receptions for the year. He's got four today. They needed four, they got eight. First down and 10 at the 25. Movement, now we've got flags. Yates hit hard. Ball up for grabs and caught inside the 10. Ryan Taylor again.
Yates pass is complete to number 49, Ryan Taylor. But
I don't think Emerson, the corner, David Emerson, ever finds the football. This was a play that was designed to go to the right, and he gets cut off.
Offside. Defense number 35. Penalty decline. The throw of the play is a first down.
This is a play that North Carolina wants to roll right. All the receivers are flowing right side. He's going to continue to move, and he gets cut off by Audie Cole and throws this up, and Emerson never found the football. That's an excellent job by Taylor to elevate and catch this ball.
What a job by Ryan Taylor today, his fifth catch. He's played tight end, wide receiver, linebacker, H-back. He's played offense and defense. Played them both against NC State in 2008. Left side, knocked out of bounds, inside the 5-yard line. So Drone looked at that flag, couldn't get there. Pick up a three.
The last time they got down in this area, NC State was able to bow their back and hold them to three.
Sean Drone goes out of the ball game. Anthony Elzey comes back in for the Tar Heels. Jones goes wide left. Adams to the right. The ball is batted incomplete. J.R. Sweezy again used all of his 6'5 frame. Big, tall, long, made the bat down.
Boy, he's an impressive player now. 6'5, 295 pounds. Sweezy leads the defensive line in tackles, which means, and he's fifth on the team in tackles. He's a tremendous athlete at the defensive tackle spot. He's been chasing T.J. Yates all over the field, and Sweezy almost came up with the biggest play of the game right there, an interception.
What the coaches love about Sweezy is he's gotten bigger and stronger without losing his burst.
Right up here's Taylor.
Third down and four. Yates. Incomplete. Batted down by Nate Irving.
If you watch North Carolina much, you know that they like to throw the ball to the tight end on these short plays. Nate Irving knew that too. He'd done his tape study. He realized that, hey, I've got to make sure that I shadow the tight end here, and he almost intercepted a back-to-back interception opportunities there for NC State.
So the Wolfpack bows its back, makes a stop. Casey Barth with a 21-yard attempt, trying for his third field goal of the day. And it's good. It's always fun when these two get together. And it's another good one this afternoon. We are glad to have you along on the ACC Network today, an exclusive presentation of Raycom Sports. Everybody looking for a seat. These folks went over to the construction site at the end of the stadium.
What do you think those seats are going for right now?
I know what they'll go for eventually. More than I can spend.
You had to know somebody to get that seat.
Let's see how they respond here. This is T.J. Graham. Find some room out across the 35-yard line. Time to update our AT&T fan vote. We asked you this question. Which coach, who do you want to win the game? You see the results on the screen. Thanks for participating in AT&T's fan vote. Tom O'Brien comes away the winner there. We'll see how NC State comes away here this afternoon. They need a win to stay in the hunt.
Yeah, everything on the line now for NC State as we play this final 30 minutes.
Mustafa Green in the ball game for NC State. Play action. They were looking for Green. He got tied up. Now they go to Green, and he can't hold on. There was penetration by the defensive line, and Green had to go a little bit around him rather than get out into the flats.
Excellent job by widening the play, and exactly what you're talking about there, Tim. But then another job by Paige Moss. Now, we've mentioned his name a number of times. He got the pressure that didn't allow Wilson to pull the football down and run. They've done an outstanding job of forcing him outside the hash marks and not letting him get downhill.
A little bit surprising. Russell Wilson has now missed his last five passes. Straight ahead goes Green. Not much there. It'll bring up third down and long. Mustafa Green was the ACC player of the week in that game against Cincinnati. But there was absolutely nothing there for him that carry.
Well, North Carolina's countered with their nickel package now. Five defensive backs on the field, and they bring in Zach Brown, who's a sub linebacker but leads the team in tackles. Number 47 is on the field.
Williams and Davis to the top of the screen. Spencer to the bottom. Third down. They need nine. One-on-one. And the play is made. Terrific play made by Jabari Price, the freshman.
It's a very simple equation now. What they're doing is they're coming with more than NC State can block, and they're forcing Russell Wilson to throw the ball quickly to the outside. Now, as a corner, you have to make the tackle. There's nobody else out there. And a great job of getting him on the ground. Jabari Price, we saw Bernie make a tackle very similar in the game. But the key to this for North Carolina State is they're not getting anything on first down, which allowing North Carolina to play the way they are.
This is Jeff Ruiz. Leffler has been punting all day. Ruiz comes in and gets a high punt that takes Searcy all the way back to the 11. So Tom O'Brien making a switch at punter, a 48-yard punt. And I'm guessing we'll see Jeff Ruiz the rest of the way. Timeout on the field. 8-11 to play in the third period. Franklin Street will be jammed after this game, but right now, dead street. There's a part of North Carolina tradition, Ramesses, named after Jack Merritt, who played back in 1922. He was called the battering ram, and so they brought in the ram, and they named him Ramesses. Good crowd here on a great afternoon in the fall. Late November, Thanksgiving weekend approaching, and the football title still up for grabs in the Atlantic Division. This is Anthony Elzey, who had a strong start to the game, picks up five. Manning makes the tackle.
Well, Elzey was a huge factor in the passing game. Had 92 yards receiving in the first half. Some on screens, some on checkdowns. This is what this was, a checkdown for the first touchdown of the game. And he has made a difference in the passing game. It's allowed Yates to get some intermediate throws as well.
Sets up second down and four. Try to throw underneath, they do. This is Elzey again, breaks a tackle across the 30. Breaks another to the 40. Anthony Elzey having a terrific game. His final home game of his career. Finally tripped up by Marcus Kuhn.
He's going to go out in style now. Elzey has been unbelievable in his passing. Great timing on the screen. Does a good job of catching the ball down around his shins. And then gets up the field, vision up the field. Over 100 yards in receiving now.
Clock continues to move into third. First down, North Carolina. Yates under pressure. And incomplete. Great pressure by Nate Irving. Lost his feet, but ended up at the feet of Yates, and Yates just rolled right and threw it away.
Yeah, but all you have to do is move the quarterback, take him off his set point, and it changes how the pattern unfolds from a timing standpoint. Outstanding a job again by Irving. Now, Elzey steps up to try to take him, but he decided to go low, and you can't blame him for that because here comes a Mack truck right at you. But he made T.J. Yates move his feet, which forced the throw away.
Butkus Award semifinalist Nate Irving having a spectacular year. Second down and 10. Yeah. Yates throws a strike. And Highsmith has a first down for the Tar Heels. Earl Wolf makes the tackle, but it's a pickup of 12.
I just like TJ's ability to sit in, his confidence to sit in, moving the eyes, anticipation, and then throw it in the middle of the field. I think he's got uncanny anticipation to throw the football.
T.J. Yates now needs just 8 passing yards to get North Carolina's career passing yards record. Throw it outside to Jones. Jones has some blockers down inside the 30, and Carolina is on the move.
And we have a new career passing yardage leader after that play.
Pickup of 22. He only needed 8.
Darian Durant, who was an unbelievable hero player here at North Carolina. T.J. goes by, T.J. Yates goes by. But a good job on the zone, on the screen, to the outside, to Dwight Jones.
Virginia Tech did a great job on Jones last week. He had only 1 catch. Oslin Carmichael were on the coverage most of the day on Dwight Jones. That's not what beat Carolina. They had 6 turnovers, 4 picks, 2 fumbles. Yates came back today with a vengeance, and here's another missed tackle. And Elzey slides his way all the way down to the 21-yard line.
You don't see this very often now. Audie Cole out on the edge, one of the outstanding linebackers for NC State, is not going to bring Elzey down. And it tells you how hard he's running. 42 Cole. Outstanding tackler. Elzey was able to run through that and pick up an additional 2 yards.
Now at the end of this, watch number 56, Nate Irving. He comes in and gets hit by his own guy coming over the top. Now Nate Irving has gone out of the ball game. Sterling Lucas comes in. Yates again, now with plenty of time, throws into the corner, incomplete, should have been caught. That's Dwight Jones again, and that ball was put right where it needed to be.
Yeah, they ran a little high-low to the left side, had a receiver in the left flat to pull the corner up, and that was Jones working against the safety Wolf. Watch the back in the flat's going to hold the corner, and they're going to throw in behind the corner against the safety.
ball that Jones has to catch.
Nate Irving comes back into the ballgame at linebacker. North Carolina just 3 of 10 on third down conversions. They've missed their last four. This is third down and they need five. Yates, else he's not going to get it. J.R. Sweezy once again with a terrific play.
He's impressive, isn't he, Tim Sweezy? We talked about he leads the defensive line in tackles, but he just does a good job of playing off blocks. If you do not double-team Sweezy, you're not going to get him blocked. Does a good job of playing off the one-on-one man setup and gets in around the legs, throw the back, and puts him on the ground.
So Casey Barth comes back on for his fourth field goal of the day. This one's from 38 yards. It's long enough, and it's good. Right now, Casey Barth may be the most valuable player for the Tar Heels. Butch Davis thinks so. We'll be back after this word from your local stations. .438 to play in the third period. Carolina now has taken a 19-10 lead. And all of a sudden, NC State starting to feel a little pressure, I would assume. They've got to get this mojo working offensively and with special teams.
Let's see if North Carolina employs what they've been doing the whole game, and it's a short kickoff to prevent NC State from setting up a return.
Well, the NC State defense has certainly done its share. T.J. Graham goes around the right side, tries to get by the first man. Well, this is the 100th anniversary of this game, and these two teams celebrating those 100 years with a lot of fervor. Russell Wilson last year threw four touchdown passes to give the Wolfpack a one-point lead in the fourth quarter. And the Tar Heels had to roll to get back in it with a chance to win. About 5 minutes left in the game, Allen Michael Cash blocked the field goal attempt as the Pack went on to win its third straight against the Heels, 28-27. And today we celebrate the 100th anniversary.
Like we had offset, there was a flag on the field. I think it was offsetting personal foul penalty. So good job by NC State to get the return. They kicked it deep, got a good return. And now it's going to be about NC State trying to be positive on first down. They've struggled here in the second half on first down.
Offense has to get going. Washington is the lone back down into the corner. This is complete to Spencer. Spencer has the first down into North Carolina territory.
What an outstanding route. Spencer runs the corner route. O'Brien is the tight end. Watch the tight end to flat. Hold the corner. Holds the corner short. Now throw it in behind the corner right there to Spencer. That is a classic high-low play on a corner in a two-deep coverage setup. You got a safety over the top, deep half, corner up short.
Carolina once again in the two-deep, five under. Wilson has to double pump and throw it away. Butch Davis once again out on the field complaining that he's throwing the ball out of bounds with no receiver in the area within the tackle box. He wants intentional grounding.
And he's got a point. By the letter of the law, Russell Wilson is doing what he can do. He can throw this football. There's no question about that. This is a throwaway, folks. He's throwing this ball away. But you see the tight end right there, that buys him that little area where he can throw it over the top.
Here's Washington around the corner. He's got some room. Oh, what a great play defensively by Carter to save the first down and maybe more. Washington got around the corner for eight. Had Carter not pushed him out, he might have had six.
And it's really the first time NC State's been able to get the edge. Look at the edge block. They get a job. Good job pulling out in front. Zach Allen, the right guard, gets the block, and Washington finds room to the outside. It's the first time we've seen NC State get the edge today.
Third down and a long one. Wilson has the first inside the 35-yard line. Again, Bruce Carter and Bernie make the stop. They needed one. They got three.
Well, we saw Nate.
Both Carter and Bernie are down.
We saw Nate Irving getting up slow. This has been a physical football game, as you would expect. And Bruce Carter is still down.
Carter's been running sideline to sideline, just saved a touchdown on the other side, came back and extended himself to make this play. And by doing so, his body became vulnerable.
Well, Dana Bible has been sparing on running this play right here with Russell Wilson. This has been a play they've gotten some mileage out of over the last couple weeks, the zone read play. He's only run it a couple times, and that was a key moment. He needed a third down conversion. But he knows that if it all comes down to Dana Bible right there, offensive coordinator, he realizes if they're to win this football game, Russell Wilson is going to be the guy that's going to get it done for him.
ACC football next Saturday at noon. We'll be with you. We're still waiting to find out where that will be. NC State very much in the title hunt. Maryland plays Florida State tonight. Wilson, look out. Dante Page Moss having a monster game. That's four sacks for Carolina this afternoon.
Now, we talked about it coming in. How can you break down protection? North Carolina does a good job of overloading NC State's left side. Zach Brown, 47, the linebacker, goes wide. Tackle steps to take him. Nobody takes Page Moss through the B gap.
Loss of eight, and brings up second down and 19. And here he comes again. And that's going to be incomplete. Great catch by Graham, but he's knocked out of bounds. And could not get his feet in.
Yeah, a little play action fake. Now Graham's going to run up the field and run the bench route, which is a little sideline to the bench area. Waited a long time, and part of that was because Russell Wilson got flushed so wide out of the pocket he couldn't get himself in a good throwing position to let it go. So Graham had to wait on it. Subsequently, the throw is out of bounds.
Stadium comes alive. Third down and 19. Wilson with room. Still on his feet. Gets a block. Wilson inside the 15. Inside the 10. Russell Wilson. And there's a flag at the end of the play.
Well, we talked about living by the sword, dying by the sword. North Carolina has been bringing pressure all day long. Well, if you don't hem Russell Wilson in, which they don't do here, he's going to get outside versus man coverage, and there's nobody accounting for the quarterback. This is going to be a late hit on Russell Wilson out of bounds.
After the play, personal foul, late hit, number 90, defense, half the distance to the goal, automatic first down.
Quinton Copels is number 90. He gets charged with the late hit. It's a pickup of 35 yards for Russell Wilson.
Great job by Russell Wilson to avoid the pressure, and then he becomes a tremendous athlete. Takes the big hit on the back end, but what a great job by Russell Wilson. They wanted a middle screen or a middle throw there. Because there was so many North Carolina bodies, he skates outside and makes a big play.
State had only 28 yards rushing up to that play, and he picked up 35. Here's Davis, slammed by Bernie.
This is just who wants it more on the sideline. This is a quick screen to the outside. It's one-on-one. And a good job of Bernie playing off the block. And a textbook tackle. Boy, this one made Tim Brandt start frothing at the mouth right there, huh?
Second down. They need three for the touchdown. Into the corner. Tremendous play by Bernie. This place is rocking.
It's the short side of the field, so you kind of understand why NC State's attacking that area. But remember, a true freshman on the other side of the field, Bernie, a senior corner who has 9 career interceptions. Watch out for Russell Wilson here.
And goal from the 3. They're not going to get there. Now a decision has to be made.
I think you got to kick the field goal here, Tim. You need 2 scores. You got to kick the field goal. I don't think there's any question about that.
Fans in Raleigh remember the 4th-and-1 in Clemson. NC State's trying to win a championship.
Tom O'Brien may feel like, hey, we have not had a chance to get down here. We're going to take our shot right here. Remember, the true freshman is right up here. Jabari Price, the freshman, way up top.
Wilson buys time, is in trouble. Throws to the corner of the end zone. Incomplete.
And this ball was batted down.
Touchdown.
And caught.
Touchdown, NC State. That ball was flopping around there. Now there's a flag down. It's going to be excessive celebration.
Now this is going to be a personal foul. There's a punch thrown. North Carolina, an NC State player got in a North Carolina Tar Heel face, and then the North Carolina player threw a punch.
Well, I want to see this one again.
And it's going to be Reddick, who's their inside linebacker. Starting middle linebacker throws a punch.
What a great job by Wilson to give his guys a chance. Now watch the ball. Now I thought it hit the ground there, but I was wrong. That is a great catch.
Spencer. Owen Spencer catches the ball before it hits the ground.
Spencer takes it right off his shoe top.
But the ensuing melee that went on is a...
Here's the call.
The previous play is under further review. The ruling on the field is a touchdown. After the play, personal foul, number 5 of North Carolina State. He has disqualified himself. Personal foul, number 48 of North Carolina. He has disqualified himself.
Yeah, the ensuing melee after the... It was ruled a touchdown. And there you see Spencer get the arms underneath the ball. That certainly looks like there's nothing there that would turn that over.
No, that's a good catch.
Outstanding job. Now the ball's ripped out late. And here's where you start to get. You see Reddick 48 there, and Jarvis Williams is number 5. Those two are going to get into it.
Well, he said Reddick, he thought Reddick stepped on him when he was getting up. And those two went after it. You saw the ball ripped out. That's when I thought it was incomplete, because it was bang, bang. So Reddick has been disqualified, number 48 right there. And Darryl Davis, wide receiver for NC State, number 15, has been disqualified.
Here's the end of the play now as the touchdown's being ruled to the left there, and both of them start swinging at each other. And that's with the flag. Good job of the officials to really get the two parties involved. Because you're talking about two big timers now. Reddick, the starting inside linebacker for this team, number 2 on the team in tackles. And also Jarvis Williams, who leads the team in touchdown receptions for NC State. Both guys are gone.
And now we're told it's Jarvis Williams who has been thrown out of the ball game. Let's take another look. There's the catch.
Reddick is to the right of the play. He's the one battling for the football with Spencer. See, right here, Reddick. Reddick's going to come in and rip the ball out right there. He rips the football out. And then went ahead and put the knee in. Went ahead and put an extra little extra knee in at Spencer.
Still sorted out as they continue to look at it.
And here's another thing, Tim, that's lost in this whole thing.
Oh, there's the little kick that we were talking about by Reddick.
It's 4th down now. How about Russell Wilson's frame of mind now, or presence of mind, to put the ball up to give them a chance to score? Remember, it's 4th down now. They don't get a lineup again if this play's incomplete. It's 4th down, and he's out of trouble. He's out of time. He lets it up. He knows he's got big, tall receivers. Gives them an opportunity.
Now, we've been told two different things. At first, we were told Darryl Davis had been thrown out, number 15. Now we're told it's Jarvis Williams, number 5. So we're trying to get clarification on that. Reddick has already left. Let's go downstairs to Mike.
Well, you're right, Tim. It is Jarvis Williams, number five. It is 48, Kevin Redick. They have both left the field of play. Interesting that coaches on both teams now are trying to get these guys to calm down. It's one of the things in a rivalry that you get. These guys are only 20 miles apart. A lot of them know each other. Some of them hang out together. And I can tell you now that this is a great game here late in the game in third quarter. Starting to get a little chippy. Birds are starting
After
to fly
further review,
these guys.
The ruling on the field is confirmed. It is a touchdown. After the play, number 5 of North Carolina State, number 48 of North Carolina have disqualified themselves.
So it is Jarvis Williams of NC State who's been disqualified. Kevin Redick of North Carolina has been disqualified. There's Russell Wilson looking on. Here comes the extra point attempt. This is Josh Chakowski. Good hold, and the extra point is good, and it's a two-point ball game.
Tim, I talk about Russell Wilson hanging the ball in the back of the end zone. We saw it just last Sunday in an NFL game where an NFL quarterback threw the ball out of the end zone on fourth down and gave his team no chance to win. Russell Wilson here, junior quarterback, outstanding player, possibly player of the year in the ACC, extends the play and hangs it up, and essentially it's a Hail Mary throw. It just happens from the 2-yard line, but he hangs it up there, and you've got big time receivers. Spencer's the guy that comes down there.
Well, this is not the first time there's been confusion and a little bit of controversy in this series. It came down to the final seconds with the Tar Heels leading by 6 in 2004. T.A. McClendon apparently scores the go-ahead score. One referee signaled touchdown. The officials then had to huddle and a spot at the 1. On the next play, McClendon stuffed short of a touchdown. He fumbles as the Heels recover, and the Heels win it 30-26. And it was on the same side of the field we just saw that play, with Spencer with the touchdown and Williams and Redick thrown out. So with 52 seconds left to play in the third, it's a 19-17 ball game. Look out. And again, Carolina will start with pretty good field position. Want the latest info on your favorite ACC teams? Then check out the new team pages section of the ACC.com. Brought to you by Toyota. See exclusive ACC video features as well as player and team insights from the Raycom Sports Blog Network. For content you can't find anywhere else, visit ACC.com. Bloggers right now typing furiously about this game. Sean Drone in the backfield for Carolina. Yates throws over the middle. This is Jones. Jones, big gainer. Move the chains. Gain of 16.
A nice feel for the game now between Yates and Jones. Jones going to reach out and snag this with the right paw. Watch him reach up, just pull it in. Boy, excellent job. Good concentration. And the wherewithal to get north and south of the football.
Jones with now 4 catches. He has 45 receptions for the year. Clock moves, 25 seconds left in the third. Yates again on play action. Backside pressure and thrown away.
A good decision to throw that one away. T.J. Yates had good pressure on the backside from Augustine, but he wanted the quick hitch to the right side, and time C.J. Wilson squatted down on it, he'd thrown it out there. Wilson may still be running to the far end zone.
So it'll bring up second down in 10. Yates again under pressure and goes down. The third sack on Yates. Audie Cole will be credited with the sack. It's a loss of 6 as the third quarter comes to an end.
Well,
That's an excellent job of dialing up some pressure to end the quarter and really give NC State some momentum, having scored a touchdown and also putting the quarterback on the ground, forcing a third and long.
Well, emotion is high. The 100th time these two teams have met, and it's coming down to the final 15.
Ready to start the final 15 minutes from Chapel Hill, North Carolina. We're in Kenan Stadium for North Carolina, NC State. Here are the score by quarters. It's a 19-17 ball game. T.J. Yates in North Carolina with the ball. It's third down and a taxi ride. They need about 16. And Yates goes down again. Earl Wolf, who's having a terrific ball game for the Wolfpack. That's the fourth sack of T.J. Yates.
Well, they come with pressure. They're going to come with pressure here, and Wolf is going to come off this side. Pressure off both edges. Cole and Wolf, and Wolf gets credit for the tackle, but good job by Adi Cole coming off the back edge as well. It's brought more than North Carolina could block.
Wolf is the second leading tackler today. He has 11 tackles and one sack. Terrific ball game by Earl Wolf. Here's a high spiraling punt. Graham will take this inside the 15. Get a block. He's got some room. Look out. Graham out to midfield. Still on his feet. No flags. T.J. Graham is gone.
This gets the wall on the sideline. Look at the wall right there. And here's the last chance for the kicker to try to get Graham on the ground. Coming into this game, Graham's longest punt return was 15 yards. He just shattered that with the biggest play of the game.
And NC State has taken the lead. Jokowski comes on for the extra point. And it's good.
T.J.
Graham, 87 yards. And all of a sudden, it's 24-19, North Carolina State University.
T.J. Graham, 87-yard punt return for a touchdown, the third longest in NC State history. As a matter of fact, the longest that they've had in years. Darryl Blackman had a 65-yarder against Maryland way back in 2006. But that 87-yarder, the third longest in NC State history, and gives the Wolfpack the lead. 14:07 to play. This is taken by Moletti. And Moletti gets across the 20, not a whole lot more. Well, this run was special.
Well, Tim, let's go back and look at it. You see all the North Carolina players are inside. You have to be in your lanes to provide some kind of picket fence in front of Graham. There's nobody in the lanes to the outside, and once he gets past the gunner, he just has to make the punter miss. And Feagles can't make the tackle. Good job of Graham seeing what was going on the field and finding that crease on the sideline.
I think C.J. Feagles outpunted his coverage, and you're right, they weren't in their lanes, and all Butch Davis could do was shake his head. Got a North Carolina State player down as they look at his right leg. Looks to be C.J. Wilson, number 20. No, correction, that's 26 as he sits up, so that's Curtin.
I think it's more about his shoulder than it is his leg, Tim. He was grabbing his left shoulder. But he is talking about his right leg as well. He's pointed. I think he got a little double dip on that one.
Asante Curtin is a 5'11", 214-pound senior.
And a key special teamer now. He's second on the team in tackles and special teams tackles.
Time for our Progress Energy Progress Report as we look at the stats through the three quarters. And they have just dramatically changed. You see, the time of possession is still in North Carolina's favor, as are yards per play.
Here's the key now for both these teams is the third down conversions. 7 of 22 in the game. Who's going to find a way to convert on third down and keep themselves on the field?
24-19 NC State.
Almost the entire fourth quarter still to play. T.J. Yates straight ahead. Elzy, tough split. Not a whole lot there for Anthony Elzy. He picks up one.
Good play by Muggio, the big defensive tackle. We talked about Sweezy, but Muggio is a heck of a player, too. Number 90 on the inside. And again, both these defenses, we talked about how the offense has moved it some, but weren't able to score touchdowns. These defenses have stiffened here in the second half.
Second down and 9 for Yates. Trips to the bottom. This is Jones. Jones back to the 29-yard line. That's it. Audie Cole got there in a hurry. Pick up a 5. Not nearly enough for the first.
Audie Cole, great big player. 6'5", 240-pounder. Outside linebacker. Outstanding job of sidelines. We talk about these linebackers all day long, but Audie Cole, another play on the outside.
North Carolina just 3-for-12 in third down conversions. They need 5 here. Yates with pressure goes down again. Reese Camp got their first 5 sacks of T.J. Yates. Oh, the defense has stepped up for NC State.
Well, it looks like they stunted Rieskamp back to the inside. No one home to take him, and it's similar to what North Carolina was doing to NC State. They're finding a way to occupy the offensive tackle that side with an outside rusher and then looping the defensive end back to the inside. We've seen it with Paige Moss, and now Rieskamp makes a play.
And Graham is going to get another chance at it. Much better punt. High kick that he'll have to fair catch, and ball's on the ground, but he gets it back. Let's go downstairs to Mike.
Guys, one of the great players in NC State history is wide receiver Torrey Holt, who has just retired after a great career in the NFL. He's been with the team all week. Matter of fact, he had a pep talk to the team about what they can accomplish here, and he's been on the bench all day long. And matter of fact, I'm going to walk over here and get a chance to talk to him. Torrey, what do you think about this team, and what did you tell him earlier in the week?
Oh, I was just encouraging him just to go out and just continue playing hard. They're in a special place at a special time right now, so just seize the moment. My brother Terrence and I, we went out and had a chance to talk to him, so it was great. And the guys are playing well. We're fighting back. We just got to finish.
Great to see you, man.
See you.
Tim?
I had the privilege to call his game against Florida State. He had one of the best games I've ever seen out of a player like that. Green with a nice big gain. First down, move the chains. Pickup of 11. So NC State now, Art's trying to get him in chunks.
Well, Green's just going to come out of the backfield. All he's going to do is check out here, and then he's going to release right here in the fly, right here in the over the middle of the ball. A little play action fake. Linebackers losing, and a good job of Wilson finding him. That's just a check down now. But they see zone coverage. And again, Wilson's ability to see what's going on secondary wise, get the ball out quickly.
First down and 10 at the 48. Russell Wilson now becomes extremely dangerous with his legs and his arm. Green around the corner. Stays in bounds, close to a first down. It'll be short by about 2 yards. Sturdivant knocked him out.
Now, this is the kid I think that Tom O'Brien feels like is his closer. Now, he's a freshman, but Mustafa Green is a physical, finish-the-run type player. He's an outstanding receiver out of the backfield, but he has some little pop to him when he gets to contact. And I think that's why you see Green in the game now. Even though he's a freshman, he's a finisher.
More now than ever before in this ball game. The cornerbacks, the secondary, and linebackers have to be aware of Wilson's legs. Here he is. And he's got the first down. You just feel it as a defensive player. His legs now on this side of the field become paramount.
Oh, I don't think there's any question that North Carolina's done a good job of keeping Russell Wilson from beating them on the ground. This was a zone read play. He knew he had a couple yards to get, and he was able to get to the edge. And for the most part, North Carolina really has done an outstanding job of taking away one facet of Russell Wilson's ability to beat him, and that's running the football, save the one play in zone coverage where he scrambled and made the big run.
Mustafa Green goes out of the ball game. James Washington comes in. Washington is your setback. And now he's your ball carrier. Around the corner, slips two, A helmet flies. We hope there's not a head in it. Opal's made the tackle, and he's the one that lost his hat.
But that's a good pickup on first down if you're North Carolina State. You're just trying to advance the football in a positive way on first down. Where we talked about how tough it's been for both these teams to move it. That's a nice 5-yard pickup on first down by James Washington.
Right now, NC State does not have to be in a hurry. They can melt the clock and shorten the game. Use every bit of the play clock. The one thing they don't want to do, though, is lose their rhythm. Green breaks the tackle, has the first inside the 25. Juan Sturdivant made the tackle, but not until he picked up 11.
You have to wrap this kid up now. You've got to hit him down the middle if you're North Carolina. Coming straight ahead. You'll see he runs through the arm tackle right there. And then he's going to drag Sturdivant for another 2 yards. There's a little bit more going on now for North Carolina State everywhere. Wide receivers blocking. They realize they're back and have a chance.
88 is Peyton. He's a redshirt freshman. Got after him pretty good. Under 9.5 to play. Green slams ahead.
Straight ahead, little lead play, gets Sturdivant blocked in the hole, and then Green going downhill. He's an impressive runner now.
Gain of 7. It'll set up second and short. That's a great job again by Peyton, the freshman.
That's what live rivalries are all about right there.
Go hard to the whistle, then show sportsmanship. Washington checks back in, has a hole across the 10-yard line to the 9. Sturdivant again makes the tackle. That's enough for the first down. It'll be first and goal for the Wolfpack.
Well, how about Dana Bible now going to the ground attack? This is something they haven't been able to do all day long, but they've loaded it on this young offensive line's back and are blowing holes now. This is, we haven't seen this the whole game, and all of a sudden, his young offensive line is coming off the football and pushing North Carolina around.
Mustafa Green back in the ball game. And Mustafa Green is inside the 5 to the 3-yard line. This is good old-fashioned football now. Straight ahead, no fair dodging.
I don't think they've thrown the football yet. Just lined up. Running the football with Green and Washington. Gone wide one time. Washington went wide one time, and Russell Wilson kept the football on a zone replay wide to pick up a first down. Everything else has been straight downhill.
And a timeout is taken. No, a flag flown.
False start. Offense, number 62. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Oh, that's a bad mistake by Duran Christoff. He's a freshman.
Well, and that changes the drive significantly now, Tim. You're second and goal from about the 3-yard line. And now you're shoved back and you got 8 yards, and it becomes so constricted down there. Now you have to be guarded if you're North Carolina, because now Russell Wilson, and you mentioned it, Tim, his ability to run with the football becomes a big point of this right here.
Second down. Here's Wilson. Not much.
Number 16, Russell Wilson.
A gain of 1.
Zach Brown, number 47, leading tackler on this team. He completely shadowed Wilson on that play. This is a guy in Zach Brown that is number one on the team in tackles. He's a junior linebacker, but he's a sub linebacker. He comes in special situations, but he is so athletic. They've got him tracking the quarterback.
He's a 60 meters man, runs the 60 meters at 6.72, and he got out there in a hurry that time. Certainly one of the fastest guys in the team, track guy. George Bryan, the tight end, was calling for the play, came to the sidelines to ask for it. Third down. Spencer to the 2. Cersei made the tackle there. It's a gain of 5.
That's a good play by 52 Sturtevant. Sturtevant's going to come from the inside and really cut off the play right there. And then Searcy comes in and finishes it off. But Sturtevant, the linebacker, we've talked about these linebackers all day long. Another great job of one of these outstanding linebackers from one of these two teams making a play.
NC State sends out the field goal kicking team, so that penalty cost him dearly. Kowski was said to be out for the season. A pulled hamstring, but he's come on, and here's your 19-yarder and timeout.
There is a flag on the line.
No, it's a flag. So
delay a game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Fourth down.
So they'll move it back. Not much of a problem there for Chukowski.
Tim Beck, when you played in the hash marks right where the numbers are now, that was the way you did it. You got took a penalty there to give you a good angle, right?
This would be a 24-yard attempt. State has hurt itself on this drive, the end of it anyway. And he drills it.
Well, that's a key field goal now because it takes a touchdown and a two-point conversion for North Carolina.
8-point game. Emotion hitting the peak. 5:41 to play in this great rivalry. You're watching exclusive coverage on the ACC Network, an exclusive presentation of Raycom Sports. Tim Brandt, Dave Archer, Mike Hogwood with you. Closed captioning for ACC football brought to you by Bojangles Famous Chicken and Biscuits. It's bow time, and it's go time now for North Carolina. They need a touchdown and a two-point conversion. 5:41 to play. Todd Harrelson gets a couple blockers in front of him and returns it just over the 20. 15-yard return. Carolina was rolling along and continued to lead most of the ball game, but all of a sudden, 2-yard touchdown reception by Spencer. Graham returned the kickoff, 87 yards. Chukowski had the 24-yard field goal, which very well could have been a touchdown. They were down a second and goal at the 3. Christoph moved, and they moved him back. But the momentum definitely has switched to NC State. 5:35 to play. Still plenty of time and only a touchdown and a 2 behind. This is Elzy. Elzy's got a big gainer. Elzy out to the 35-yard line.
Another good job by T.J. Yates to get this ball out. He wants to throw a 3-count screen. Well, it turns into a count and a half because Augustine comes off the edge and he just dumps it to him in the flat. What a good job of throwing it from a really severe angle by T.J. Yates. Boy, Elzy is impressive in his timing and feel for the passing game.
That's a pickup of 17, and if NC State's defense plays soft, Carolina will make them pay. First down from the 38. Little screen. Elzy again. Around the corner. Has a blocker. Elzy's got room. He's inside the 30, inside the 25, all the way down to the 21-yard line.
Get back-to-back screen passes to Elzy, and they obviously have something going on. Elzy's what he's going to do is he's just going to idle down right here. Line's going to get out in front, and they're going to dump it to him on the screen. Back-to-back screen plays. See the two big guys get out in front. Manning gets picked up on the block. Excellent kick-out block there on Amerson. And, boy, a touchdown-saving tackle right there by Wolf.
So Elzy picks up 17 on the previous play. He gets 42 on this play. And North Carolina is back in business. Yates on first down, hands it off. Drone carries it inside the 20. Manning makes the stop.
Different package in the game that time. Two backs, two tight ends. Power running game set. And they run the football. They've thrown the bootleg out of it. And NC State was covering the bootleg. Job of handing it off and running it.
Anthony Elzy checking all his parts.
Boy, he has been outstanding today.
Carolina needs 7 on second down.
to the 15-yard line.
Good move by Drone in the hole because Manning is free off the edge. He made Manning miss. Watch him make number 35 Manning miss right there. And then he slips back to the inside, and Wolf hangs on for dear life. Looked like he grabbed hold of the mud flap and held on.
It'll bring up third down and five. Carolina has not been real efficient on third down this afternoon. Drone tiptoes through the line, breaks the tackle, and is down close to the first down, be a little bit short. Manning made the tackle, gain of three. And it looks like they'll be about a yard and a half shy.
This is something North Carolina's done all day long in third down and medium situations, 3-6. They've been willing to run the football. And this time Drone comes up just short, and you make that decision if you're Butch Davis because you realize you are certainly going for it here on fourth down. That's nothing left in the tank. You got to go now.
2:30 to play. 10 on the play clock. Fourth down, North Carolina. Incomplete. No, he makes the catch. He went through his hands and he caught his own deflection. What a grab by Adams for the first down.
Josh Adams, the redshirt freshman, almost drops this and then catches it. Little bootleg play, ball out wide. He tipped it to himself. What a play by the redshirt freshman from Cambridge, Massachusetts.
Oh, my, what a play is right. First and goal, Carolina inside the 10. Yates is sacked. Irvin got there first. Six sacks on Yates.
Well, when you don't know what to do, send 56. Because he tends to finish the play. He had a monster day last week against Wake Forest. 8.5 tackles for loss. And he has come up big in the big moments in this game.
An 8-yard loss on the play. Second and goal from the 16. Play action. Here they come again. There's the screen, incomplete. Drone couldn't get out of the backfield.
And again, Tim, at the big moment, we saw Elsley walk in the sideline. Now, he's now standing next to the coach, but not in the football game, and he's been the most effective back for North Carolina. That time, they wanted to throw the screen again. And that time, Drone got caught up in the traffic. Remember how well Elsley has been slipping to the flat. Elsley not in again. Drone in at running back.
Third down and goal from the 18. Correction, 16. Yates with time. Over the middle. Has a complete. Touchdown, North Carolina, Eric Highsmith.
Question now, North Carolina will have to go for two. But what an outstanding job by John Shute to get the wide receiver isolated on the linebacker, Adi Cole. Highsmith comes to the inside. Just an outstanding job of getting the football to Highsmith on the delay route to the inside versus the backer. We're going to take a look at this to see if he got in the end zone.
Watch where the ball is when his knee hits the ground. I think they're going to bring it back.
Yeah, it certainly looks like he's short of the touchdown. But I just love the design to get one of your receivers locked on the wide receiver Highsmith. You love the little chess match that goes on between defensive coordinator, offensive coordinator.
Can't tell from that angle. You know what? That ball may have broken the plane before his knee hit.
And therein lies the issue, right, Tim?
If you don't have indisputable video evidence, they will not overturn the call on the field, which was a touchdown.
This is our best look at it, but can you tell right there?
That's a distorted angle.
Yeah, can you tell if it's not over? And I don't know that they have that.
I agree. But as you said, if and when North Carolina scores, they have to go for two. Percentage of two-point conversions, 43%.
Yeah, it's give or take, 50-50 there, 43%. But this is where this actually gives John Shoup an opportunity to get the play he wants, and it gets you to preserve your timeouts. Remember, if North Carolina doesn't get this, they're going to have the onside kick, but then they also have the timeouts in their pocket to try to get a stop as well. So there's a lot going on here in the minds of North Carolina's coaches.
The question is there enough evidence from this angle? It is a distorted angle, but from that angle, it doesn't look like the ball was across the plane when his knee touched down. It's not where the knee touches down. It's where the ball is when the knee touches.
Well, remember the Elsley play on the other end of the field where he extended the football. We talked about, did it hit the pile, and it didn't. But they couldn't tell from that angle whether he had gotten inside the one or where it should be spotted, so they left it right where it was. I think you're going to be a similar situation right here.
And the band plays on a glorious afternoon in Chapel Hill. What a spectacular football game this has been. Great effort by both teams.
Day when North Carolina's seniors arrived, having never beaten NC State, trying to get that one victory before they leave campus. And North Carolina State hanging on tooth and nail for an opportunity to play for an ACC championship.
Tom O'Brien trying to go to 4-0 against the Tar Heels. And we continue to tell you how big this ball game is. This is a must-win for State. Florida State wins the Atlantic Division with a win at Maryland tonight. State wins today at Maryland. If State goes up and wins out today and next week, they win the Atlantic Division. Florida State needs help. And Maryland, if it wins its final two games, wins the Atlantic Division. So
after
NC State
review,
and Maryland control.
The runner's knee was down prior to the ball breaking the plane. The ball will be placed at the 1-yard line. It is fourth down. The time is correct, and we'll start on the ready for play.
Well, you can look at this from a couple of angles. Certainly from a North Carolina angle, maybe not a bad thing. Obviously, you want the score, and you've got to get the ball in the end zone to have a chance to tie this football game. But with a minute 18 left on the clock, and Russell Wilson on the other sideline, should you have gotten the two-point conversion, maybe too much time for Russell Wilson. So this is an opportunity for you to maybe run the clock out and still score.
Fourth down and goal from the one. Carolina 2-for-2 on fourth down conversions. For NC State, this is huge. For the 17 seniors at Carolina, this is huge. Play action. Yates, back of the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina.
The patience of T.J. Yates here, because Wilson stumbles coming off the football. Wilson, and Yates has to hold it an extra count. He wanted to let it go, but he had to hold it, because as Wilson regained his footing and then turned around, and Yates put the ball on him.
Now they move the ball back to the three. Carolina needs the two-point conversion. Yates rolls right. Got trouble. No good. Seconds remain. It's 27-25 NC State. We'll be back. ACC is now on Facebook. Log on to Facebook. Become a fan of the Atlantic Coast Conference. You can get breaking news, conference updates, and connect with other ACC fans from around the world. ACC on Facebook. 27-25 NC State. Time remaining, 65 seconds. Here comes the onside kick. Get a good bounce. NC State recovers it, but there is a flag.
and the guy that's going to recover this is TJ Graham, I think number six, and he runs up at the last moment from the deep back position to get in position, and he actually makes the recovery. He's the last guy in the mix. I'm not sure if he was lined up incorrectly right before the kick or what, but they called him up right at the end.
Offside on the receiving team, number 87. 5-yard penalty, free kick.
So that's a big break for North Carolina. Offsides on NC State. .104 left. They practice this every single day.
Well, this is one, Tim, that you don't do live, though. That's the problem with this play, is you don't do this play live because you don't want your players running into each other. So this is kind of a hit or miss type situation. You walk through it on a Friday and you kind of mimic what's going to happen, but nobody's running into each other. Now all of a sudden you add the train wreck element to this thing, and this can get crazy.
So here we go again. This is a little pooch kick. Fair catch. Graham takes it at the 39. TJ Graham with a fair catch at the 39, and it's NC State football with 104 to play.
Well, the thought process now behind that is, as a defense, you're going to come in through three timeouts, you're going to try to get stopped. You have three timeouts in your pocket, you try to stop them on three downs, force the punt, and then you've got to go down the field to get the field goal range with no timeouts in the pocket.
This broadcast is a copyright presentation of the Atlantic Coast Conference. Any use of this broadcast without the permission of the ACC and Raycom Sports is prohibited. NC State trying to melt the clock and get out of here with a 27-25 win. Just hold on to the ball, snap it, and hold. Washington wraps it up. They wrap him up, and he goes down for a loss. Dante Pagemoss makes the tackle. Timeout with 1 minute left. So with timeout in the field, we'll take 1-2.
Jared McAdoo. For the media timeout.
ACC football has been brought to you by CPI Security Systems, by your local Toyota dealers, and by AT&T.
I don't know why anybody's leaving this stadium. 1 minute left, 27-25 is your score. NC State leading by two. NC State with the football. Here's the give to Washington. They're rapping and ripping right now. And so it'll bring up third down and 11. And they stop the clock with 53 seconds.
Washington on the carry.
National recording artist Montgomery Gentry headlined FanFest during ACC Football Championship weekend in Charlotte. FanFest has something for everyone and is highlighted by a greatest hit show from these country music stars. Get your game tickets now. Don't miss this free event being held on Saturday, December 4th, prior to kickoff. Visit accfootballcharlotte.com for tickets and a whole lot more. What a weekend that will be. Also, fans, let us remind you that the ACC, they're able to stay connected with ACC Sports via their iPhone or iPod Touch with the all-new official ACC Sports app presented by Avalon. Download today for breaking news, video clips, and real-time scoring of all ACC football and men and women's basketball games. Visit theacc.com for more information or search ACC in the iTunes store. For a limited time, the app remains a $1.99 bargain. Three seconds left. 27-25. Carolina's got one timeout left. And NC State's going to have to punt. Paige Moss made the stop on Washington. So the Tar Heels aren't dead yet. Well, we all take you back to the window of time and remember the 1986 game, which was one of the true classics, and just like this. The score tied with 3 minutes left in the game after North Carolina fumbled on their own one. They drove 99 yards, did it.
NC State with the go-ahead touchdown. Eric Kramer was in, but Carolina took over. 1 minute remaining, and Mark May completes five straight passes. Dick Crum decided to go for two, and the win, the pass to Dave Truitt, ruled incomplete because his knee was on the ground. 35-34.
Well, this game is played out exactly here at the end the way Butch Davis had envisioned. You don't get the two-point conversion. You stop NC State and get use their timeouts. The only thought process is maybe you've kicked it deeper if you're going to use your timeouts. At this point, you're just trying to get a hold-up return, try to give Searcy a chance. I don't know that you come after this. If you do, then that makes Searcy is going to have to fair catch the kick. But you're certainly going to be in position now with T.J. Yates trying to move his team into field goal range.
Low snap. Punt is a tail wagger, and it's short. Searcy lets it hit and roll inside the 10 to the 5 to the 4-yard line. How does he not pick that up?
Well, what a poor decision not to catch the football. You have to catch the ball. You have to sell out and catch the ball.
A 57-yard punt.
And you saw Butch talking to Kendrick Burney. He's the up man. Remember, Burney made a catch on a short kick earlier in the game, and he was discussing it with Burney. Could you have caught that football?
She agrees with you. So 36 seconds left for T.J. Yates. They need to get him in a hurry. They've got to get in field goal range. Yates in the has it complete. Drone stops the clock by going out of bounds. A pickup of six. They need more than that. Clock down to 31 seconds.
Yates can throw the ball short of the first down marker as long as it's going out of bounds. Everything else has to be beyond the first down marker, or at least to get a first down so the clock is frozen.
Keep in mind, Casey Barth has a strong leg. He hit a 49-yarder in the first half. But the offense has to get this ball way downfield. They got to get more than six on these plays. And they've got to use the sideline. Yates again in the end zone. He's going down. That's a safety. And this game's over. Manning gets the safety, and they're going to have to give it back to NC State with 27 seconds left. Seven sacks on the day for NC State's defense.
How about the fact that it's one of those linebackers for NC State that makes the play? We've been talking about Adi Cole and Nate Irving. And here comes Terrell Manning right up through the middle and puts T.J. Yates on the ground. T.J. had no chance. He wanted to put his foot to the ground and drive it to the outside. No chance to let it go. What an outstanding job by the linebacker core. It just flows from sideline to sideline for NC State.
And the air immediately comes out of this stadium. And with 27 seconds left, I got to believe it's another onside kick. Now they need a miracle. 29-25 NC State. They'll attempt the onside kick. And now they need a touchdown.
North Carolina State obviously counters with their hands, too. They've probably run this play more in the last 2 minutes than they've run it all season long.
Got to go 10, gets a good hop, and knocked out of bounds. So NC State will get the ball, and that will do it. 27 seconds left. Russell Wilson just needs to take a knee.
Well, what a great job by NC State to come into a hostile environment in a game that meant so much to a senior class that had not been able to beat them. Russell Wilson, his receiver corps scoring in what, about 17 points in about an 8-minute process there in the fourth quarter.
And so NC State will control its own destiny with 1 week to play. Now Maryland has to win tonight against Florida State, which sets up a monster game in College Park next Saturday. Tom O'Brien came into this program. NC State had lost six or more games in five of the previous six seasons. And now Tom O'Brien has them at 8-3 and very much in the title picture. Russell Wilson with another strong game. Let's go downstairs to Mike Hogwood. Michael.
All right, yeah, we're down with Coach O'Brien. Down in the second half says a lot about your team, the fight that they had today.
Well, we just grind it out. I mean, that's who we are. We're not flashy. We just keep working, and we made things work for us. These kids deserve all the credit, and the coaching staff does.
Well, you got what you want. Next week, you play for the title in the division and a chance to go to the championship game.
Yeah, this was a twofer. We got to beat Carolina and play for the championship. It ain't better than this.
All right. That's a word from Tom O'Brien. Big smile on his face. We'll be back in a moment after this word from your local ACC station.
Reminder to log on to theacc.com for our next telecast. It'll be Saturday at noon. Well, a spectacular afternoon. 29-25, NC State comes away from North Carolina with its fourth straight win over the Tar Heels. For Dave Archer and Mike Hogwood, I'm Tim Brandt. You have been watching coverage of Atlantic Coast Conference football on the ACC Football Network, an exclusive production of Raycom Sports. Once again, your final score, NC State 29, North Carolina 25. So long from Kenan Stadium, everybody.